to $100, and it stayed about that level up into probably 2010, until we upped the ante to $500, and then we added in an iPad, and then later on, for the last few years, it's been $1,000 for the winner of the Key to Victory Search each year.
I mean, now I you get a better understanding why people are so anxious. I mean, because it's fun, and you get bragging rights, but, I mean, I could use $1,000, and I'm sure most of these college students do too. You know, we had a couple other you know, events throughout the week. You know, give us some of the other highlights. You know, from your vantage point.
I guess from our vantage point, the highlights was one, we were able to dodge the rain and the fire ban, and we were able to pull off not only our bonfire this year, but also the homecoming fireworks show. So that went off great. We were very excited about that. But then the rains really came in and put somewhat of a damper on our annual alumni event last night, but it was still a very good turnout for the people that came out in the rain. And even though we were confined to the indoor spaces up until about, I would say, 9:30, 10 o'clock last night, it still was a great outing and I think a very good time for our alumni to get back together and reconnect and get geared up for today.
It was really cool. I had an opportunity to go to the alumni event, and you know, the rain did kind of slow some of the crowd coming in there for a time, but it was awesome because, you know, I saw recent graduates, and I saw some graduates, and had dinner with a couple that you know, graduated back during the Livingston college days, and so that was really neat to see. The parade today, I didn't get a chance to see the parade. I was driving in the parade, and from my, you know, seat in my Jeep, it seemed great. But you know, kind of give us a rundown of the parade and your take on how it was in compared to years past.
I think it was a great parade. We started off the morning just getting some things geared up and making sure things were in place for the lineup of the parade, and I was able to run across campus in a four-wheeler and check on some people, sprinkled just a little bit and had us a little hesitant at first, and then, as you know, there were some great football games on TV, so I was able to take a break in between the parade set up, see some of the game, and then actually step out on the lawn of the president's home and watch the parade come by. And it was a great parade. We had some very, I think, innovative floats that came through. The rodeo team was back involved with the parade for the first time in a number of years. I was really surprised and pleased with the two young men with the wheelbarrow and the shovel at the end to make sure they took up anything that the horses may have inadvertently dropped along the way. But
their collection duties there, yeah, yeah. I was kind of questioning that when I come up to the booth, and I was like, you know, what's the short straw that you have to draw to get that? And I was told by a very reliable source that both of those young men volunteered eagerly, but I think they were coerced with the, you know, the almighty dollar or two or 25. I'm not sure exactly how all that went down. But, you know, it's homecoming. You've been to the home games here. You made the trip to Valdosta. What's your take on what we're going to see today? What do you want to see out of the Tigers?
I'm looking forward to the Tigers coming out and making a dramatic showing for homecoming. They look powerful in the red today. I know Shorter is not having the best of years this year, and I don't see any reason why the Tigers won't put on a show for us today here in Tiger Stadium.
I would definitely agree with that. Well, Richard, I greatly appreciate you coming up and visiting with us, and I hope that we can get you up here from time to time to get some more insight on what's going on, especially in the area of student affairs, admissions, and that kind of thing. But thank you for all that you do, and look forward to having you up here the next time.
I appreciate being up here, and I've got to give a great shout out to Big Mike's. They are sponsoring the Tiger Room activities today, and it has been the best Tiger Room lunch I have had probably in the history of the Tiger Room. Very proud for their effort today.
Now I wish I could have gotten here a little bit earlier to get down there. But you guys, we are about 25 minutes away from kickoff here in Tiger Stadium. Plenty of time to get there. So make plans to attend. And Richard, thanks again for coming on.
Thanks, Willis. It's always a pleasure to see you.
Awesome. Well, we're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, we will be able to break down a little bit more about the contest here on 104.9, the Tiger Radio Network. Oh.
Or you can leave it up here. We can have fun with it. You can go ahead and raise these. Yes. Let me get this thing over here so we don't have to try to strap. Very innovative system.
Free safety number 8, Jeremiah Boyd. Safety number 1, Tavarius Hutchinson. At my linebacker number 2, Corey Proctor. At will linebacker number 21, Josh Hatchett. At linebacker number 4, Michael Anderson. At defensive end, number 9, Terrence Jones. At number 54, Andre Lewis. Marcus Williams, number 7, Jordan Jones. The presentation for the Tigers. Kick off. Kicking and coming. From 17, Matt Gaines. Ball snapper, number 59, LaTrell Hatton. Kick return. Number 2, Christian Salisbury. Number 8, Bruce Martin. Punt return, number 25, Chris Thurman. And holder, number 89, Bailey Blanchard.
Also, be sure to pick up your game day roster card located on the home side concourse as you enter Tiger Stadium and as well as the visitor's gate.
Welcome back into the Sumter County Farmers Federation Tiger Tailgate Show. Just over 20 minutes away from today's contest between West Alabama and Shorter. The gold standard of inventions might be sliced bread, but we know differently. We know there's only one cheesy, saucy, delicious treat that just about everyone can agree is one of humankind's most shining achievements, pizza. Granted, we might be a bit biased, but since there's such thing as National Pizza Month, we can't be too far off. After all, sliced bread doesn't get its own month. No one is more passionate about pizza than Pizza Hut. It's in our name and it always will be. Pizza Hut, a proud sponsor of UWA Athletics. And Will, don't always get a chance to update everybody, but have five former Tigers in the NFL. Tyreek Hill is a game time decision tomorrow. He's been battling a collarbone injury this offseason. Hill signed a $54 million contract extension with the Chiefs. Malcolm Butler is with the Titans. So far this year, he has 23 tackles and one interception. The Titans will travel to Denver to play the Broncos tomorrow. Seth Roberts, wide receiver with the Ravens, has seven receptions for 83 yards on the year. The Ravens will host Cincy tomorrow. Deion Lacey is with the Dolphins. He has three tackles on the season as the Fins will face the Redskins in a battle of winless teams. And then D. Virgin has two tackles on the season for the Detroit Lions, and they will take on the Packers in an NFC showdown on Monday Night Football. You know, it's amazing that a school this size, Division II, has five players in the NFL.
It's awesome, and it's hard for me to wrap my head around it because it's a big deal to get into the league. And you see teams like your Auburns and Alabamas and Floridas, and you know they send guys to the league with some regularity. But the fact that West Alabama has five guys in the league just is a real testament to what type of product that they have put out on the field here. And you know, I just think that really goes back to what type of guys that we're bringing in and how the recruiting has gone, and West Alabama has had some really strong recruiters in the past, and Coach G and his staff have done a really good job to continue that tradition.
And not only having five guys in the league, but having two stars. You've got Tyreek Hill, who's one of the most explosive players in all of the NFL. And then you have Malcolm Butler, the Super Bowl hero, who has been a very steady contributor, not only with the Patriots originally, but now with the Titans. And so it's great, as we saw earlier, all of the recruits in here to watch the game today, for them to know, I can go to West Alabama, not only can I make it to the league, but I can be a star in the league if I come here.
Absolutely. And I think that's also a great testament to Division II, so that guys that are out there right now, they're grinding in high school or their community college or junior college, whatever level that they're playing at, they don't have to set their sights. You know, if making it to the NFL is a goal of theirs, they don't have to set their sights and say, you know, if I don't go to a Power 5 school, I'm not going to be able to make it. You can 100% come into a place like West Alabama and not only display your talents and hone your skills, but you're going to get recognized because the GSC, this league is the real deal as far as Division II. So, you know, I'm really proud of those guys, and I'm sure that we're going to have more in the future. And, you know, a tip of the cap to the entire Division II as a whole, because, you know, there's more to college football than just what we see, you know, on ESPN.
Turning our attention to some of the stars that are on this year's team with two catches today, Quay Boyd would move into the top five all-time in receptions. He currently sits in seventh with 115 receptions over his career. One ahead of him is Chad Tuchek and Andrew Fields, who each have 116 career receptions. So with two receptions today, he will move into the top five all-time in receptions. Also, Zach Gaines continues to stay at the top of the punting average all-time at West Alabama. Over his career, Zach is averaging 43.38 yards per punt, and that distance between he and Jordan Eichner, who is second on the list, just keeps increasing each week with Zach. Zach is averaging over 48 yards per punt this season, with 10 punts being 50-plus yards. Also, Bailey Blanchard is 19 yards shy of having 1,000 career receiving yards. So all very incredible. And, you know, it's hard to really put into words just how special Zach Gaines' season has been so far this year.
This guy is amazing. And if you never seen Zach Gaines, like, in person, if you've only seen him on the field, you can tell on the field, like, he's a big guy. But, like, this guy looks like he could play linebacker for any team in our league. And he's a punter. And, you know, you talk about the punts over 50 yards. Think about the ones where he didn't get an opportunity to really put all of the leg in it. So that has hurt his average through no fault of his own. So, you know, it's a real testament to not only what he can do, but the consistency at which he can do it.
We are under 15 minutes away from kick. When we come back, we will get a chance to hear an interview with Coach Brett Gillen talking about the season so far and also to preview a little bit about what we should see from the Shorter Hawks. You're listening to West Alabama Football, the Sumter County Farmers Federation Tiger Tailgate Show on ESPN 104.9. Hey, Aubrey. Aubrey, you there? Hey, how do you want to do the coach's interview? Okay, do I need to hit F2 or are you going to do it? Okay, and when the interview's over, keep it with us and we'll wrap it up and then go to commercial again, okay? All right, thanks. Hey, how long is the interview? Okay. Welcome back into the Sumter County Farmers Federation Tiger Tailgate Show. Earlier, I had a chance to visit with head coach Brett Gillen and get his thoughts on today's game.
And we'd like you to stay in the parade when we leave the tent as we honor America with our national anthem. Star Spangled Banner will be performed today by Miss UWA, Katie Johnson, and accompanied by the UWA Marching Tigers, directed by Mr. Michael Tinkler.
That was head coach Brett Gilliland talking about last week's disappointing loss and also looking forward to today's game. And Will, you could really tell, yes, he is disappointed about last week, but they're ready to put it behind them. And great thing about football is you get to come right back out the next week and get things going right again.
Well, if he weren't disappointed, like, we would have a problem, so I get it. I mean, I've coached, and when we've all, you know, been disappointed when our teams haven't done well. But you're exactly right. I mean, Coach G, he knows that you're going to have, you know, adversity sometimes. I know that with they preach the brotherhood throughout this ball club, that they're ready to rise to the challenge today. And, you know, we've got a great day for it. It finally feels like fall. It's an overcast day, a little cool. I actually see folks wearing sweatshirts today, so really exciting. To be here at homecoming here in Livingston.
Nahiola Credit Union has been proudly serving its members since 1959 with branches in Livingston, Demopolis, Butler, and Pennington. Nahiola is the bridge to all of your financial needs from checking, savings, loan services, and much more, including serving as a proud sponsor of UWA Athletics. Nahiola Credit Union, simple. We are just under 6 minutes away from kick. When we come back, we will get you set for this matchup between West Alabama and the Shorter Hawks. You're listening to the Sumter County Farmers Federation Tiger Tailgate Show on ESPN 104.9.
Some of the games are part of the D2 official pre-game. I can overlook and love the pre-game. You can have a time. Over a decade, our fans will be back to support the sport and our kids' efforts. Represented the safe, fair, and competitive contest.
for that critical part of the student athlete experience. Join us now in appreciation for the support of our student athletes at today's game with a warm round of applause. Thank you. Captain for today's game. First, for Shorter, for 73, Jake Mikowski. Number 41, Chip Williams. Number 3, Chief Officer here. Number 40, DJ Wallace. And your captain for your Titans, number 17, Zach Gant. Number 75, Brandon Anderson. Number 18, Quay Boyd. Number 9, Harris Jones.
Welcome back to Tiger Stadium. The captains for both teams are at midfield. Today, serving as captains for the Tigers will be number 75, Brandon Anderson, number 17, Zach Gaines, number 18, Quay Boyd, and number 9, Terrence Jones. As we mentioned, Shorter is 0-5 overall, 0-3 in GSC play after losing 44-34 at West Georgia last week. Shorter is coached by Zach Morrison. He's in his second season with the Hawks and is 0-16 in those two seasons. Morrison is a former player, in fact, was on the first Shorter football team as the West Alabama team takes the field, being led out by the cheerleaders with the band playing the fight song. Shorter will take the opening kickoff. West Alabama won the toss and deferred, and so Shorter will start with the ball first. Shorter has lost 44 consecutive games. Their last win was all the way back October 3rd, 2016 against Mississippi College. So coin has been tossed, band is about to clear the field, and we are ready for football. And after last week, it's good to be able to get back out there and put that bitter taste, get that bitter taste out of our mouth and get back to some winning football.
Absolutely, Robert. And, as folks are still filing in, West Alabama is going to be decked out in the red jerseys today with the white numbers. They're going to wear red pants with the red headgear. This will be the first time that they've worn this color combination this year, so looking to get on the winning track with this color combo. Shorter's going to have on white jerseys with blue numbers. They've got it's kind of a gray pants there with some blue accents, white helmets with the single blue stripe down the middle, as both of these teams are huddled up on their respective sidelines, and we're about ready to kick this thing off.
Coach Gilliland giving the kickoff unit some last-minute instructions. Coach Gilliland's in his sixth season at the helm of the Tigers. He is 40-23 as head coach. Those 40 wins put him at the top of the all-time wins list at West Alabama. Zach Gaines will be handling the kickoff duties once again due to Trey Jackson's injury. Jackson warmed up earlier today and from what we've been told is available on an as-needed basis, but in warm-ups you can tell that his injury is still bothering him. He's limited in his range, so wouldn't expect Trey Jackson to see much action today unless absolutely necessary, and then probably only for PATs and some shorter tight field goals. So Zach Gaines marches off his steps. Has the ball teed up, looks to his left, now to his right. And we are underway from Tiger Stadium. A low line drive kick that will hit around the 20 and then roll all the way into the corner of the end zone for a touchback. So Shorter will start first and 10 at their own 25. A little bit of good luck right there. It looked like the ball was going to roll out of bounds, but did not. Stayed on the field of play, rolled into the end zone for a touchback. So Shorter will start their first drive at their own 25-yard line. Shorter will put the ball in play at the left hash. Shorter will be led by their sophomore quarterback, Tyler Pullum. He has two running backs, one to either side of him, two receivers right, one to the left. Pullum looking to throw, throws it to nobody. Trying to hit his running back, Gregory Fields, coming out of the backfield, but good pressure by the Tigers really blew that play up before it had any chance to develop.
Yeah, you can see West Alabama seemed to be pretty amped up right there. This is going to be the first play from scrimmage, and that's going to bring up second down and 10 for the Shorter Hawks, working from their own 25 here, just seconds underway for this homecoming matchup 2019.
Two receivers stacked either side of the formation. Tupac Lanier, the running back in the backfield. Lanier gets the handoff, gets across the 25, but will only pick up about 2.5 on the play. And Will, you mentioned it after the first play, a fired up Tiger unit. You can tell that that intensity is there to start this game where it was lacking last week.
Yeah, I think they want to set the tone early here for Shorter, as you know, they made a little bit of some running room right there, but Josh Hasher was able to meet him for only a short gain, and that's going to bring up third down for Shorter.
Third and 7 for the Hawks. They have four receivers to the right, one to the left, empty backfield for Pullum. Pullum looking to throw, looking on the far sideline, has a man but overshoots him. Good defense right there by the Tigers, forcing a 3-and-out on this first possession.
Yeah, Xavier Williamson right there in coverage for West Alabama just wasn't having any of that. So 3-and-out for Shorter as their special teams unit will come on. That'll be back to receive the punt for West Alabama. Be number 25, that's Sid Thurman. He'll have his heels on his own 39-yard line as he gets ready for this first special teams play from scrimmage for West Alabama.
Brett Burden-Warper with the punt. It is a high spiraling kick that will send Thurman back to his 25. Tries to make one man miss. He does. Makes another man miss at the 20. Cuts it back across the 30. He will be brought down at the 33-yard line. Good job by Thurman right there. Had to reverse field, backtrack a bit, but was still able to pick up about 8 yards on the return.
With a lot of help right there with by number 23, Shamar Lewis on special teams. He got in there, got a little bit of a block, sprung him for a couple extra yards as the offense takes the field for the first time this afternoon. Jack McDaniels will be in shotgun formation for the Tigers.
McDaniels will send three receivers right, one to the left. Runs the option to the right. There's the pitch to Underwood. He cuts it up across the 35. It'll be a pickup of around 4 on first down.
Kind of a slow developing play right there. They're going to pick up the 4 yards, but, you know, he just couldn't make the corner as he was trying to get north and south there. He just kept stretching it toward the far sidelines. It'll be second down for West Alabama.
Second and 6 for the Tigers. McDaniels sends Bailey Blanchard from the right side of the formation to the left. Now he'll flip it to him in the left flat. He is hit immediately. after catching the pass, nothing doing there. Shorter not fooled on the play. It'll actually lose yardage back to the 35. It'll make it 3rd and 8 for West Alabama.
I think Blanchard was a little bit shaken up right there, as you can see him kind of shaking the cobwebs out as he was met head on by Tyshawn Jackson, the defensive back for the Shorter Hawks.
McDaniels claps, getting the Tigers set in their formation. Three receivers left, one to the right. Underwood, the running back, will be two jacks left. Shorter showing blitz. They'll back out. McDaniels, plenty of time to throw across the far sideline. Pass is complete to Jamoris McMillan. He has to retreat to get the reception and then lunges forward, trying to get to the first down marker. He's going to be right at it, and they will give him the first down. So Tigers able to convert on 3rd and 8. With the 8-yard reception by McMillan.
On a ball that wasn't perfectly thrown, McMillan was able to make the correction and then make the extra effort to get across the chains. First down for West Alabama, working from their own 43-yard line.
Two receivers either way for McDaniels in pistol formation. He sends Blanchard in motion. Now he will dump it off to Underwood out of the backfield. Derek cuts it up, gets near midfield. They'll give him the 48-yard line, so a pickup of around 5, 5.5 for Underwood on first.
They'll credit Ethan Manns with the stop right there and a great job right there by the tight end, Quay Boyd, who was kind of out there in space creating a little bit of blocking help to help move the chains. It'll be 2nd down and 5 for West Alabama.
Salisbury and McMillan to the right. This time they will hand off underneath to Underwood. He will push forward. He'll reach the midfield stripe, but that's it. Only a gain of 2, maybe 2.5 on 2nd down. It'll make it 3rd and a long 3 for the Tigers.
Underwood tried to get in behind Joe Oliver, the 6'4", 320-pound junior, and he inches his way to midfield, but it's going to bring up 3rd down for West Alabama here in the early goings of this first quarter.
Tigers 1-1. On 3rd down conversion so far this drive. Look to go 2 for 2. They will do it with an easy reception by Tyreek Martin. I believe there's going to be a face mask at the end of this play. McDaniels, really an easy play right there. Shorter playing well off of Martin. Martin just ran to the sticks, was able to get the first down, then fell forward. And there was a face mask at the end of it, so tack on another 15 yards. That will take the ball all the way down to the Shorter 31-yard line, where it'll be 1st down and 10 for West Alabama. McDaniels will deploy two receivers right, one to the left. McDaniels fakes the handoff to Underwood. Now he's going deep. Has a receiver in the corner of the end zone, and the pass is just knocked away at the last minute. Looked like Deion Hill was running free for a second, but the Shorter defensive back able to regroup and knock that pass down.
The thing that I dreaded all week, Robert, was that I was going to have to try to say this gentleman's name, and we're just going to call him Justin EZ, because I'm not even going to begin to try to Ezekiel Wonko. That's the best I can do.
This time, Underwood gets the handoff. He'll get inside the 30, down to the Shorter 29-yard line, but only 2 yards on 2nd down, so it's going to make it 3rd and 8 for the Tigers, able to convert their last 2 3rd downs. Here they're looking to go 3 for 3, and given the field goal situation that we discussed, the normal kicker Trey Jackson likely not available for a kick of this distance, this may be 4-down territory this early in the game at 10:15 remaining first quarter, no score. McDaniel sends 3 receivers right, 2 to the left. Jack looking to throw, look towards Boyd. Now he's going to run it on his own, is tripped up at the 32, will fall forward down to the 26, but he's going to be well short of the sticks. It's going to bring up 4th down. West Alabama offense staying on the field, looking like they will indeed go for it here on 4th down.
West Alabama having to go for it right here. McDaniel was tripped up by Terrence Snellings by the shoestrings, but it's going to be a 4th down and about 6 for the Tigers inside the Shorter Hawks territory.
Tigers 2-5 on fourth down so far this season. McDaniels floats one to the end zone and overshoots a wide open Christian Salisbury. Salisbury had broken away from his defender, and Jack could not put it there into his hands, and so overshoots Salisbury, and Shorter will take over on downs.
Yeah, Jack picked up the chink in the armor right there in the Shorter defense, but just let it get away from him. I know that's one of those 9 times out of 10 he's going to be able to put it on the money, but I think he got a little bit excited right there. It got away from him. It falls incomplete, and West Alabama will turn it over on down. Shorter Hawks will take over first down and 10 from their own 28. 0-0 your score here with 9:26 remaining in this first quarter.
Shorter will have it first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. Pullum will hand off up the middle to Lanier. Lanier will reach the 30, maybe a hair across the 30. Only a pickup of about 2.5 on first down.
Initial contact right there on the defensive front right there is coming out of the linebacker position. Number 2, Corey Proctor, he steps up and closes the gap right there as the West Alabama Tigers force a second down.
Pullum checks out, and in at quarterback is Aeneas Dennis. Dennis is more of a running threat than Pullum. Dennis will keep it and go up the middle. We'll get to the 34-yard line, so 4 yards right there. He faked the handoff to Lanier and then wanted to go around left end. Nothing was there, and so he had to cut it back up the middle. He picked up a couple of yards there. It'll bring up a third down and a long 3 for the Hawks. Tyler Pullum will check in for this third down. Pullum will have Lanier, his running back, to his right, 3 receivers right, 1 to the left. Pullum now will check the sideline for the play, 8 on the play clock, 5, 4, 3. Hawks get it off, hand off to Lanier around left end. He will have enough for the first down across the 40, and then maybe a late hit. Yes, that flag comes out late, but it looked like Lanier was hit after he had reached the sideline, and so that's going to add 15 more onto that. It will move it into West Alabama territory.
Yeah, it looked like Tavares Hutchinson was going to have an opportunity to stop him right near the sticks, but he got past Hutchinson, and then he gets to about midfield, and as he's going out of bounds, he's going to get hit late, and that's going to bring what should have been a first down and 10 from about midfield. It's going to be a first down and 10 inside Tiger territory. They're going to spot it on the Tiger 39-yard line. So Shorter, the beneficiary of a West Alabama personal foul.
Pullum will go under center for this first down play. Hands off to Lanier around left edge, makes one man miss, cannot get away from the second when Josh Hatcher was able to bring Lanier down after he had put a spin move on the first Tiger defender trying to tackle him.
Yeah, Lanier got the handoff, and the first thing he did right at the point of contact, he just does kind of the old X spin right there, and he picks up about a half a yard. We'll call it a full yard, at least second down and 9. For the Shorter Hawks, West Alabama's defense kind of buzzing around here, minus the one penalty, really done well here in the early goings in this first quarter.
Pullum in shotgun formation will send Lanier, his running back, in motion. Pullum will dump it off over the middle. The pass is complete. We'll get to the Tiger 31-yard line. It'll be a pickup of about 8 yards. It'll make it third down and a short 2 for the Hawks.
Josh Hatcher once again getting in on the stop right there for West Alabama. It's going to bring up third down for the Hawks as the defensive unit looks to the sideline getting the call, as they would definitely like to get this stop right here. Shorter doing the same, looking in, trying to get that offensive call as Pullum looks over his offense.
Cameron King with the reception on second down, bringing up this third and short. Pullum will have 3 receivers left, 1 to the right. Pullum will hand off. Lanier trying to fight forward to get the first down yardage. Believe he is going to have it. A good push by the offensive line was able to get that and check that. Gregory Fields, the running back checked in for Lanier. He got the handoff and was able to pick up enough yards for the first down. So Shorter will have it first and 10 at the West Alabama 28-yard line. 6:06 remaining, first quarter, no score so far. Shorter, three receivers right, one to the left. Wildcat formation.
Balls on the
handoff. It's a fumble. It'll be recovered by West Alabama. Shorter trying to get a little cute there. They had Gregory Fields, the running back, in a Wildcat formation. He tried to hand off. The exchange was not there. Shorter fumbles it, and West Alabama getting a turnover, only their fourth turnover that they have gotten all year, and couldn't have come at a better time with Shorter driving in West Alabama territory. So UWA will take over first down and 10 at their own 31-yard line, 5:48 remaining, first quarter, no score.
Yeah, great job right there by number 9, Terrence Jones. He's able to pick up the loose football, and that puts West Alabama's offense right back on the field.
McDaniels looking to throw on first down, trying to hit Quay Boyd on the sideline, but Jack's throw a little bit past the outstretched arms of Boyd, so it'll make it second and 10 for the Tigers.
McDaniels looking a little erratic here in the early goings with the throws. That one got away from him. Quay Boyd's quite a big target, and he overshot him by quite a ways. But that's going to bring up second down. They'll be working from their own 31-yard line. 5:44 remaining here in the first quarter. Nothing your score. Here homecoming in Livingston, Alabama.
McDaniels, a quick pitch to Underwood around left end. He'll get across the 35. He'll be met there, fall forward to the 36. So he'll pick up a 5 on second down and make it third and 5 for the Tigers. Back up on the line, looking to extend this drive. Their last offensive possession was a turnover on downs. Tigers looking to get a little bit of momentum going here in the first quarter. Two receivers right, one to the left. Jack going to throw, looking across the middle, hits Blanchard at midfield. He's at the 45-40, cuts it up at the 30-25, where he will be brought down right at the 25-yard line. Perfect slant pass right there. Jack McDaniels hitting Bailey Blanchard, and that big reception will put Bailey Blanchard over the 1,000 career receiving yards mark. Congratulations to Blanchard as he was able to just take a little quick slant route, turn it upfield for a big gain for the Tigers. They will have it first down and 10 at the Shorter 25-yard line after an injury timeout due to a Shorter defensive player who was involved in the tackle being shaken up. Johnson Dodge Chrysler Jeep of Meridian is dedicated to ensuring your auto process is a smooth and stress-free one, regardless of whether you're shopping online or on-site. They provide comprehensive sales, purchase, finance, and maintenance assistance. Stop by and pick the ride of your future. Johnson Dodge Chrysler Jeep, a proud sponsor of UWA Athletics. So 5:04 remaining, first quarter, no score, but the Tigers, for the second time, are deep in Shorter territory. The first time they were not able to cash in and get any points. Tigers looking to get on the scoreboard first here.
Shaken up on that play was number 19 for Shorter, Tyshawn Jackson, defensive back, but he was able to get up on his own power, so that's good. West Alabama first down and 10 from the Shorter 25. 5 minutes remaining here in the first quarter. Nothing your score.
McDaniels looking to throw, has Boyd at the 5. They are able to connect. Boyd will be dropped right there. Good sign to see McDaniels and Boyd on the connection. Tigers will have it first and goal at the Hawks' 5-yard line. Tigers quickly back up on the line of scrimmage. Hand off to Underwood along the left side. Derek pushes forward for the Tiger touchdown. 5 yards out, Derek Underwood puts the Tigers on the scoreboard first.
Nice job right there by Underwood, just getting in behind his lineman, able to work out to that left side of the line. As he goes in, he drags a Shorter Hawk with him. So West Alabama's on the board for first, and that last pass reception by Quay Boyd gives him 116 receptions in his career, which is a three-way tie for fourth all-time in West Alabama. Excuse me, tie for fifth.
Zach Gaines on for the PAT. Snap is good, hold is down, kick is up. and it is no good. Gaines pushed it a little bit or pulled it a little bit to the left, so the PAT is no good. So 4:43 remaining in the first quarter. West Alabama out on top of Shorter, 6-0. You're listening to West Alabama Football, ESPN 104.9.4:43 remaining here in Tiger Stadium in the first quarter. West Alabama out in front first, 6-0. Derek Underwood took it in from 5 yards out for the rushing touchdown. Zach Gaines' extra point was wide left. Gaines is now 4 of 7 on extra points this season, filling in for Trey Jackson, who is injured. Because of Jackson's injury, Gaines will also handle the kickoff duties today. He has it teed up at the 35. Gaines checks each way. And we'll send an end-over-end kick that will be fielded at the 8-yard line, be returned up the middle, across the 20, out to the 25. That was Gregory Fields, the running back that handled the kickoff return duties there. He takes it out to the 25, where Shorter will start, first down and 10.
West Alabama scoring drive, 69 yards, took 5 plays in 1:05, and they were able to find the end zone. Not able to put the PAT through, but 6-0 your score here with 4:38 remaining in the first quarter. West Alabama's defense forcing a turnover on the last Shorter possession as Shorter has it first down and 10 from their own 25.
Pullum will have 2 receivers either way, Lanier in the backfield. Lanier with the handoff. He will fall forward to the 29-yard line, so they give him 4 yards on first down. 2nd and 6 for the Hawks.
Lanier just tried to get in there behind his offensive line, keep his legs moving. He picks up 4 yards on the play, and West Alabama kind of a game tackle right there at the point of contact. So it'll be 2nd down and 6 for Shorter here.
Lanier, the starting running back, stays into the game, but he will be sent wide right. They also check in Greg Fields, the backup running back. He's in a slot formation also to the right. Pullum looking to throw, getting pressure, rolls to his right, was able to find a receiver sliding down at the 40-yard line. That was John Deedle, the third freshman tight end, who came free as Pullum was trying to escape the pressure. It'll be marked down across the 40, around the 41-yard line. That'll be good enough for a Shorter first down.
I was a little surprised. It looked like there might have been a hold right there on that last play. The defensive player for West Alabama looked a little frustrated that it was a no call, but it's going to be a first down and 10 for Shorter. Ball on their own 41-yard line, 3:25 remaining in the first quarter.
Pullum will throw on first down, pass complete, out across midfield. He'll be tackled in West Alabama territory at the Tiger 47, so good enough for 13 yards and another Shorter first down. Cameron King on the reception.
King making that first down for Shorter as they get across the midfield stripe inside West Alabama territory. Moved the football last series, but West Alabama was able to force the fumble, and obviously West Alabama would like to be able to do that again here with Shorter driving.
Field stays in the game. He will move to a receiver position. Lanier will be the running back to Pullum's right. Pullum looking to throw, has a receiver open on a slant route. It will be another Shorter first down. It will be brought down at the Tiger 30-yard line. Christian Da Silva with the reception. Nice play right there. 17-yard pickup for the Hawks. And Shorter back in West Alabama territory, threatening to get into the red zone. First down and 10 from the Tiger 30.
Yeah, Da Silva had plenty of room right there, and all he had to do was wait for the ball to be delivered, and it was. Making the tackle for West Alabama will be number 9, Terrence Jones. as the chains have moved once again in favor of shorter first down and 10 from the Tiger 30.
Pullum will throw on first, steps up in the pocket and will be sacked. The Tigers will get to Pullum. It'll only be a loss of 2.5 on first down, but a good job by that Tiger front four getting the pressure on Pullum and bringing him down for the sack.
Nice pressure up front, but also some pretty good coverage in that defensive secondary for West Alabama as Pullum just couldn't find an open receiver. So that's going to force a second down and about 11, call it 11 and a half, four shorter here with just a minute 45 remaining in this first quarter.
Fields checks out, Lanier checks in, and will be to Pullum's right in the backfield. Pullum in shotgun formation, two receivers either way. Pullum looking to throw, dumps it off to Lanier. He will pick up good yardage. Tigers will bring him down at the 23-yard line, so a pickup of around 10 on second down, but it will bring up a third and about 2.5, maybe 3 for the Hawks.
West Alabama's Jordan Jones in on the stop right there, and shorter really although they're not having any giant plays, they're continually moving the football here on the West Alabama defense here in the waning seconds of the first quarter.
Will be a lateral to Fields, who the Tigers will bring down at the 35. Shorter again, trying to get cute right there. We're setting up for a double pass. It was a lateral to Fields, the running back out of the backfield. Fields was looking to possibly throw back to Pullum along the left sideline, but the Tigers snuffed it out and bring him down for a big loss. He'll be tackled all the way back at the Tiger 34-yard line. It'll bring up a fourth down and about 14. Hawks will have to snap it before the end of the first quarter or take a timeout. And I believe Coach Morrison, chatting with the official, will take the timeout before the expiration of the play clock. So they will have a couple of minutes to sit and discuss just what they want to do here. Fourth and 14, four shorter from the West Alabama 35-yard line. Their field goal kicker.
Sniffing that one out, and I was a little shocked right there that, Shorter having some success, moving the football, went to a trick play of sorts, which really backfired. Fortunately for the Tigers and the Tiger fans here, as West Alabama's defense is coming back out onto the field.
Shorter has sent out their field goal unit.
Wow.
In to kick will be Nicholas Pope. As we mentioned, he's 4-5 this season, but his long kick is only 38 yards. This would be a 52-yarder from the right hash. Kick is up. Has the distance, but wide right. And so the Tigers give up yards once again, but no points to show for it. Four shorter as West Alabama will take over first down and 10 at their own 35-yard line. That's the last play of the first quarter. Score, West Alabama 6, shorter nothing. You're listening to West Alabama Football, ESPN 104.9. After one quarter of action here in Livingston, West Alabama leads shorter 6-0. And Will, it's a game that could be much different if the two offenses are able to take advantage of some of the things that they've had in front of them. West Alabama drove down deep into shorter territory, was not able to convert on fourth down. Shorter has had two scoring opportunities, and both times, really the drives have faltered because they have tried to get a little cute with things. The first time they went with a wildcat formation, the quarterback was not able to get the running back exchange. They fumble, West Alabama takes over, and then they are trying a double pass, get thrown for a huge loss, and then attempt a 52-yard field goal, which was no good.
Yeah, and on that field goal attempt, it wasn't like he didn't have an opportunity to put that one through. He had the leg. It might have gotten slightly tipped at the line right there, but he had the leg. He just couldn't get it to go through. But, you know, both of these teams with some opportunities here in this first quarter. Here we're 6-0 your score for West Alabama as we start the second quarter.
McDaniels with the hard count, trying to draw Shorter off sides. They don't jump. Looks to the sidelines for the play. Now relays it to the offense. McDaniels fakes the handoff to James Smith. McDaniels will throw, flips it out to Tyreek Martin in the right flat. Martin takes it up the right sideline. Will get across the 45 out to the Tiger 47-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 13 and a first down for West Alabama.
Martin was shoved out by Bradley Kirk, and, you know, Jack McDaniels took a little bit of a hit right there, but he was able to get it into the hands of the receiver. Nice first down for West Alabama. First down and 10 from the Tiger 47.
Two receivers either way. It'll be a handoff to Smith up the middle. He'll get to midfield and fall forward into shorter territory down to the 49-yard line. So a pickup of 4 on first down for James Smith.
It looked like Smith was able to get in behind the center, Carl Dyer, who created a little bit of running room, get some real estate there, and he picks up the 4 yards, gets it across midfield inside shorter territory.
Smith will be in pistol formation this time. He'll get the handoff again, tiptoes his way through a pile of Hawks. He'll get down to the 46-yard line, so a pickup of 3. It'll make it 3rd and a long 3 for the Tigers, who are quickly back up on the line.
Senior offensive lineman Cornelius Rogers, he turned his man to the outside and was able to create a little bit of running room, but 4 yards shy of the first down mark here as West Alabama is looking to convert here on 3rd down.
Shorter in their base, 3-4 defense, bring a rusher off the edge. McDaniels plenty of time to throw and drills the umpire with the football, so the pass is incomplete. Trying to hit one of his receivers coming across the middle and just drilled the umpire. And so Tigers will be forced to punt here. 13:29 left in the first half. Tigers leading 6-0, facing a 4th and 4 at the shorter 46-yard line. Zach Gaines out to punt. Gaines sends it end over end, a short kick trying to pin the Hawks deep. It will bounce inside the 20 and go out of bounds at the 18-yard line. So a nice job right there by Zach Gaines, pinning the Hawks inside their 20-yard line, a punt right there that will hurt Gaines' average, but just like Coach Gilliland said, he takes on whatever responsibilities and whatever duties the Tigers need him to do, and there sacrifices yards and his average to pin the Hawks deep.
Now, absolutely, and, you know, I was looking over the stats before the game this week. Shorter has yet to return a punt all year. And it was the craziest thing. I thought I was misreading it, but they have yet to return a punt all year. So through 5 games, they've done that 0 times.
Pullum will hand off to Lanier up the middle on first down. Lanier will reach the 23-yard line. So Tupac Lanier picks up 5 yards on first down, make it 2nd and 5 for the Hawks.
And on the stop for West Alabama is going to be the linebacker, number 7, Jordan Jones. Seems like he has been in quite a few of those tackles here in the early goings. We're hitting the 13-minute mark here in the first half. West Alabama leading 6-0.
Pullum will have 2 receivers right, 1 to the left. He's in pistol formation. Tigers bringing a corner blitz. It's a handoff up the middle. pick up 2 yards, not much doing. Good job by the Tiger front seven, bottling up Lanier on that handoff. It will make it third down, but it's third and one for Shorter.
Third down and a one for this defense as they kind of look things over to see how they're going to tackle this third down and very short. West Alabama's defense has done a pretty solid job throughout the afternoon. They definitely got to like to get a stop here as we hit the 12-minute mark remaining in this first half.
Tigers only allowing 32% of third down conversions. Tigers bringing a blitz off the edge again. Handoff to Lanier. He's met at the line of scrimmage and spun down. It's going to depend on the mark whether he got the first or not. There is a Hawk that is slow to get up. It appears it's one of the offensive linemen. But the run by Lanier was enough for the first down. He got about a yard and a half. And so Shorter will have it first down and 10 around the 27-yard line. After they are able to tend to the injured Hawk, it appears that it's Zaire Ori, the redshirt sophomore offensive lineman out of Stockbridge, Georgia, who was shaken up on the play.
Yeah, he's a big guy, 6'3", 330 pounds. As they've got him sitting up, but he definitely seems to be in some sort of discomfort there as the athletic training staff for the Hawks tend to him. In the first quarter, and to this point, West Alabama's gained a total of 114 yards, Shorter 81, Jack McDaniels 7 of 11 for 87 yards, and Tyler Pullum 5 of 7 for 58 yards in the air. West Alabama has been able to incorporate 5 different receivers, Bailey Blanchard and Tyreek Martin, each with 2 catches, and then you've got Boyd, McMillan, and Underwood, each with a catch of their own, and very similarly, 4 different receivers into the mix for the Hawks. King has 2, and Lanier, Dettle, and Christian, each with a catch of their own. So a very similar production here in the early goings for both of these clubs.
And you would expect for both of these teams to go through the air for a majority of their yards coming in to today's game. West Alabama and Shorter had the 2 worst rushing offenses in the conference. West Alabama was 8th, averaging 137.8 yards on the ground, while Shorter was last in the conference, averaging only 99 yards per game on the ground. You couple that with the fact that UWA and Shorter had the 2 worst passing defenses in the conference, and that kind of sets up for some big passing plays and the potential for the teams to really light it up through the air as the injured Shorter Hawk is being helped off the field. You can tell he has some type of injury to his right leg as a teammate and athletic trainer are helping him, assisting him off the field.
As he's making his way to the sideline, the officials have moved the chain, so it's going to be first down and 10 for Shorter. Now there seems to be some sort of confusion on the sideline. They'll get the chain set here. Looks like first down and 10 for Shorter. They'll be working from their own 29-yard line. 11:53 remaining here in the half. 6-0 your score in favor of the Tigers.
Pullum will have 2 running backs in the backfield, 1 to either side of him, 2 receivers, 1 to either side of the formation. Pullum claps once, fakes the handoff, trying to hit one of his receivers on a slant route, but Cameron King, unable to come up with it. The ball was out in front of him. It did hit King's hand, but King was not able to reel it in, and so that'll make it 2nd and 10 for the Hawks.
Jeremiah Boyd was in coverage for West Alabama, kind of blanketing right there, and he was able to get a hand on it. Ball falls incomplete and brings up 2nd down for Shorter. As Pullum looks to the sideline, he makes sure that he's got all of his staff in place as he's going to be working from the shotgun, 2nd down and 10 from his own 29.
Empty backfield for Pullum, 3 receivers right, 2 to the left. Pullum checks to the right, moves to the left, now being forced up in the pocket and will be brought down for a sack. The Tigers' 2nd sack of the afternoon, they will drop Pullum back at the 25-yard line.
In pursuit for West Alabama was number 94, John Michael Edwards, and he was able to get to Pullum and bring him down from behind there as he gets to register a sack and a loss of yards on the play. Great job by the West Alabama defense as the Shorter Hawks are going to be staring at a third down and 14, right about their 25-yard line.
Tigers looking to get off the field. Shorter facing a third and long. Pullum will throw, dumps it off to Lanier out of the backfield on the right flat. Nothing doing for Lanier. He'll tiptoe out of bounds at the 25-yard line. Be no gain on the play and will force Shorter into a punting situation.
Nice job right there by the defense for West Alabama as they force the punt right here. Coming into the contest today, Barton Werper, that's a mouthful, averaging about 40 yards per punt. He'll be standing at about his own 10-yard line, back to receive the punt for West Alabama. It'll be number 25. That'll be Sid Thurman, and he stands at his own 40.
Barton Werper's punt is a high spiral. Thurman calls for the fair catch, and it is made at the Tiger 34-yard line. So West Alabama will take over at their own 34, 10:24 remaining in the first half, 6-0 West Alabama. UWA was able to get a 5-yard rushing touchdown from Derek Underwood. The PAT was no good, and so we sit at 6-0 West Alabama here at homecoming in Livingston, Alabama. Jacob Murphy will check into the game at quarterback. He'll have James Smith behind him in pistol formation, two receivers left, one to the right. Murphy will look to throw on first down, connects with McMillan along the right sideline. McMillan tries to split two defenders, but will be wrestled down at the 45. It'll be a pickup of 11 and enough for a West Alabama first down.
Nice job right there by McMillan of knowing where the sticks are, and he works his way to the first down as Murphy brings him to the line.
He will hand off this time to Smith along left tackle. Smith's got a hole at the 40, 30, 20. He is gone. Touchdown, West Alabama. 45-yard, 55-yard rushing touchdown by James Smith.
Nice job right there. The offensive line really did a great job on the left side of containing those would-be defenders, and when Smith got to the corner, it was just open real estate as he turns on and has separation speed, and he takes it across the goal line and extends West Alabama's lead as Zach Gaines will come on to attempt the PAT. That'll be Bailey Blanchard in for the hold for West Alabama.
James Smith only needed a little bit of a crease. He got it and took it to the house from 55 yards out. This PAT from Zach Gaines is up and through. So 10 minutes remaining in the first half. West Alabama now leads 13-0 over Shorter. You're listening to West Alabama Football, ESPN 104.9.
What is it about UWA? Is it the beauty of her campus? The feeling of being just the right size? World class? Without classes big enough for the world. Is it the warmth of her people? They say there's something about this place. Maybe it's because this place feels like home. On campus or online. The University of West Alabama.
...55-yard rushing touchdown by James Smith. Zach Gaines will kick it deep to the Hawks. End-over-end kick will be fielded at the 7. Fields will take it up the middle, is hit hard at the 25, able to bounce off of that and fall forward to the 27. Good job by the coverage unit down there to make the tackle for West Alabama.
In on the stop right there, special team stop by number 36, Jake Vick, the senior out of West Blockton, Alabama. West Alabama's scoring drive covered 66 yards on two plays in a total of 24 seconds and extended the lead here 13-0 here with 9:54 remaining in this first half. And West Alabama's defense is going to be called on right here to hopefully set the tone once again. They've played with some energy here in the early goings thus far.
Three receivers right, a tight end to the left of the formation for Pullum. He'll hand off to Lanier up the middle. Not much doing for Tupac as he will only reach the 29-yard line, so it'll be a 2-yard gain for Tupac. Lanier bring up second down and 8 for shorter.
Ran out of real estate right there, did Tupac, as Grady kind of wrestles him down and then gets some help from the other Tigers here. Second down and 8 from the shorter 27 as we hit the 9:30 mark remaining in this first half. West Alabama up 13-0.
Shorter flipping the formation. They'll send two receivers left, three to the right. Pull them in an empty backfield. Pullum will throw quickly to the right. Pass is complete at the 29. He is hogtied at the 31. And so a pickup of only 2. Nice job by West Alabama to bring down Elijah Gilbert. Had a little bit of real estate, but not after the West Alabama defense collapsed on him.
Definitely had a little bit of real estate, but Trey Elston had a little bit different idea right there as he was just able to grab him by the shoulder and just wrestled him down after a short gain. It'll be third down and 6, shorter working from their own 28-yard line.
Pullum will send one receiver right, 3 to the left. His running back Lanier will be to the right of him in shotgun formation. Third and 6 for the Hawks. Hand off Lanier up the middle, has a crease, has a first down across the shorter 40. He'll be marked down at the Hawk 41-yard line, so a pickup of 10 yards right there on third and 6. Shorter catching West Alabama by surprise. You could tell the Tigers were looking for the pass, and Shorter just ran a little draw up the middle for the first down.
Yeah, the Hawks just kind of got in behind Dalton Ham, the 6'3", 300-pound offensive lineman, and the running back did the rest as he was able to move the chains, and it's first down and 10. Shorter working from their own 41-yard line as we hit the 8-minute mark here in the first half.
Another empty backfield for the Hawks. Pullum fakes a pitch to one of the wide receivers coming in motion, throws underneath, and a great job, I believe that was Hutchinson, with the pass breakup right there. Had a receiver running underneath, and Hutchinson just broke that play up.
Hutchinson did a great job of breaking it up, but also a lot of great pressure right there on the quarterback by number 5, Dorsett Johnson. He came out of the linebacker position and really put the pressure on Pullum, and he was able to make him get rid of it a little quicker than he would like to. Second down and 10 from the 41.
Pullum looking to the sidelines for the play. He will change it at the line. Shorter has a tight end on the left side of the formation. That's John Deedle. It'll be a handoff to Fields. Tries to go to the left. Now has to reverse back to his right, and he will be brought down for a 2-yard loss. Great job by the Tigers setting the edge on that right defensive side. Forced Fields to reverse field, and Fields was brought down behind the line of scrimmage, a loss of 2. It'll make it 3rd and 12 for Shorter.
Yeah, when he had to reverse the field, he got tangled up with his offensive lineman, number 58, Nehemiah Bing, and that forced him even farther back. So a great job right there by the defense. 3rd down and 12 for Shorter from their own 39.
Pullum walks to the line, barks out some orders for his offensive line. They will hand off again on third down, this time to Fields. This time it does not fool the Tigers. It'll be a pickup of 7, but he's still going to be about 6 yards short of the line to gain, so it'll force a punting situation for the Hawks.
That'll bring on the punting unit for the Hawks once again, and West Alabama's defense playing a bit more inspired football as they're able to force the punting unit onto the field once again. Back to receive for West Alabama will be number 25. That's Sid Thurman. He's making his way to the far hash. He'll have his heels on his own 20-yard line awaiting the punt from Barton Werper.
Barton Werfer's punt is another high spiral. Thurman will field it at the 16, makes two men miss, cuts up the middle at the 25, will be tackled out across the 30-yard line. So a nice job once again by Sid Thurman, making a couple of people miss and picking up a good return average right there. Got about 12 on that return. So West Alabama will set up shop, first down and 10 at their own 32-yard line, 6:06 remaining in this first half. West Alabama leading shorter 13-0.
Thurman averaging just over 9 yards per return. Done a great job right there as he's able to bring it out beyond the 30. First down and 10 from the Tiger 32.
McDaniels back in at quarterback. Three receivers left, one to the right. Demetrius Battle gets the handoff now. He's across the 40, 45, 50. Big man rumbling down the near sideline. Gets into shorter territory. Have to see where they mark him. They're going to give him all the way to the shorter 37-yard line. So a great job on first down for Battle, getting that big yardage. Went up the middle, then cut it to the outside. They fake it this time to him. Quick pass in the near to the near sideline to Bailey Blanchard. It'll be a short pickup right there. He will have it at the 34-yard line. It's only a gain of about 4 on that first down play. It'll make it second and a long 6 for the Tigers. Demetrius Battle still in at running back after his long run. He will be behind McDaniels in pistol formation. Demetrius will get the handoff this time. Not as much room, but he is able to push the pile forward to the 30. It'll be a pickup of about 4. It'll make it third and short for West Alabama.
Battle's such a big back. I mean, he's listed at 6'2", 240, redshirt freshman out of Birmingham, Alabama. And he's just a, you know, he's a guy that I think as he continues to get reps and matures is going to be a great back for West Alabama as they're looking at a third down and 4 from the shorter Hawks 30.
McDaniels looking to throw, trying to find Boyd. Passes tipped up in the air and intercepted by Shorter. They will return it down the far sideline and finally be brought down at the Shorter 26-yard line. McDaniels right there taking a chance, throwing it up in the air, hoping Quay Boyd was going to be able to come down with it. The pass was deflected up into the air, and another Hawk was able to leap up and make the interception. So that's the first turnover for the Tigers today and ends that promising drive. Shorter will take over first and 10 at their own 27-yard line. 4:46 remaining in this first half. West Alabama leading 13-0.
Yeah, just a really ill-advised throw as McDaniel tries to put it into double coverage and Boyd wasn't able to knock it down, and an interception by Nehemiah Reddish.
Quick slant across the middle is broken up by Jordan Grady. Nice break on the ball, was able to get to the receiver right as the ball got there, and so the pass goes incomplete. Second down, 4 shorter.
Grady got there in a hurry and just was able to break that pass up. It falls incomplete as Pullum looks over the offense. He's going to deploy 3 receivers here to this near side, 1 to the far side with the running back to his left.
Second down and 10 for shorter, 4:42 remaining, handoff to Lanier, tries to break it outside but will be thrown for a loss back to the 26-yard line. So it'll be a loss of 2 right there, bring up third and 12 for the shorter Hawks.
Jordan Jones is going to record his 5th tackle of the afternoon as he wrestles the running back down just shy of the original line of scrimmage. So it's going to be third down, we'll call it 12, as the West Alabama defense kind of trying to flex its muscles here a little bit and force another punt by the shorter Hawks.
Lanier will be the running back, 2 Pullum's right, 1 receiver right, 3 to the left. Pullum looks to throw on third down, going deep, has a man, passes complete at midfield. He will be tackled by Tavarius Hutchinson in West Alabama territory. They'll mark it down at the 48. That pass is good for 27 yards and a shorter first down.
Xavier Williamson was the defensive back that kind of lost contain right there, but making the stop for West Alabama is Tavares Hutchinson, but not before the Hawks are able to get it across midfield, move the chains. It'll be first down and 10 inside the Tigers' 48-yard line.
Pullum this time will have two receivers to the left, one to the right, running back to his right. Tigers show blitz, back out. Now they come with pressure. Pass along the right sideline is complete. It will cross the West Alabama 40. It'll be marked down at the 37-yard line. It'll be a pickup of around 12 and a shorter first down.
Yeah, he was able to hook up with his tight end, number 38, Brock Jackson, and that moves the chains. And Shorter showing a little life right here with 3 minutes remaining in this first half, trailing 13-0, but moving the football on this drive.
Shorter has been able to move it consistently here in the first half, but have had a tendency to self-destruct. See what happens on this possession. This play will be a handoff to Lanier. Lanier trying to fight his way through the line. He will pick up about 3 yards on first down, make it second and 7 with 2:42 remaining in the first half. Shorter still has two timeouts remaining, so plenty of time for them as they are taking their time. Team is at the line, but everybody facing the sideline getting the play. Now Shorter will make substitutions. Tight end and receiver go out. Tight end and another running back come in. Shorter with two running backs in the formation, but both are at receiver positions. Fields is at a slot position. Lanier split wide to the left. Pullum looking to throw. Forced up in the pocket. Will gun it down the far sideline. Pass is broken up by Hutchinson. Nice job by Tavares to break on the ball. Had a receiver open, Cameron King, but Hutchinson was able to get there and deflect the pass away.
King listed at 6'3", 215, and Hutchinson just kind of came in there and was able to leap high above the would-be receiver and knock it down. That's going to bring up third down as we hit the two-minute mark remaining here. West Alabama leading 13-0 with Shorter looking at a third down and 7.
Pullum will send three receivers left, one to the right. Running back will be in the backfield to Pullum's right. That's Fields, who tries to make a cut and goes down. Nobody was there to force him down. Fields just lost traction and will be dropped around the 36-yard line, so may have even lost a little bit of yardage there. There's a timeout on the field. West Alabama takes the timeout at 1:52 remaining in the second quarter, trying to preserve a little bit of time for maybe the offense to get one more strike and force Shorter to do something here on fourth down again. Shorter has it at the West Alabama 36-yard line. So from here, you're looking at a 53-yard attempt. Last time out, Nicholas Pope missed from 52. He had the distance but pushed it to the right. So a field goal here is an option. Shorter down 13-0, 1:52 remaining in the first half.
Yeah, Robert, he does have the leg, and West Alabama would definitely like to not give them that opportunity here and maybe get one more crack at having the football here to extend this halftime lead. So it's fourth down, four Shorter, fourth and 6. The ball's on the West Alabama 36-yard line. We've got a minute 52 remaining, and Pullum brings his offensive unit out onto the line. He'll deploy two wide receivers to the near side, two to the far side, and he'll have one man in the backfield standing to his right.
So Shorter will go for it here on fourth down. So far this season, they are 1 of 6 on fourth downs. Greg Fields, the running back, is sent in motion to the left. Pullum will try to run. Now he looks up, throws downfield. Pass is incomplete. And so West Alabama will take over on downs. Interesting right there. Pullum sent the running back in motion and then looked like he was going to run it and really had.
He had it.
He had enough real estate there. If he just elected to run it, he could have run for the first down and at the last minute looked up and saw a receiver breaking deep and chose to throw it that way. Pass was overthrown, goes incomplete, and West Alabama will take over first down and 10 at their own 36-yard line, a minute 47 remaining in the first half. UWA still has two timeouts. McDaniels, flushed from the pocket, moving to his right, throws across the field to his running back, Underwood. The pass will be caught at the 45. It'll be a pickup of 9. The clock still running, a minute 33. West Alabama back up to the line. McDaniels will hand off to Underwood up the middle. He's hit at the line, falls forward. He will have enough for the first down. That'll momentarily stop the clock at a minute 24 remaining in the first half. West Alabama will have it first down and 10 at their own 49-yard line. Clock moving now to minute 21. McDaniels sends three receivers left, one to the right. Underwood, the running back, is behind McDaniels. Fake to Derek, looking to go deep. Now he checks it down underneath to Underwood. Underwood will get into shorter territory, will be right at the yards to get, but they will say he is just short of the first down line. Underwood shaken up on the reception. He checks out. James Smith checks into the game. 50 seconds now. Hand off to Smith, who breaks it to the right, tries to cut back up, but nothing much doing. He will get across the 40. It will be a West Alabama first down. That'll stop the clock at 44 seconds. Tigers back up on the line, electing not to use one of their two remaining timeouts. McDaniels looking to throw, dumps it off to Smith at the 40, who cuts it up, will be tripped up at the 32-yard line. He stayed inbound, so the clock was moving. West Alabama will take their second time out of the first half at 29.9 seconds remaining. So a good job right there. West Alabama able to get some yardage, only had to spend one timeout, still have 30 seconds left in which to try and score before this half ends.
Yeah, they took control of the football on about the shorter 40, and they have, the West Alabama 40, but they have been able to move the football pretty well. They've had a great tempo and an awesome job right here, a series that has seen Smith get really involved, being able to catch a couple of passes, and Jack McDaniels being able to deliver, and also the offensive line giving him some running room as Smith's got a couple extra carries here. As we're looking at 29.9 ticks of the clock remaining in this first half, West Alabama leading 13-0, and definitely would love to see a few more points added on here going into the locker room at halftime. Jack McDaniels will bring his offense onto the football field here for this second down attempt.
West Alabama will get the second half kick, so would like to try to get a 2-for-1 here if they can. McDaniels will look to throw, being flushed from the pocket, getting pressure from behind, able to get rid of it. Pass is complete to Bailey Blanchard, who steps out of bounds at the shorter 25-yard line. Still 24.6 seconds remaining in this first half. West Alabama back up on the line. Three receivers left, one to the right. James Smith, the running back, behind McDaniels in pistol formation. Jack looking to throw, getting pressure, and will be dropped at the shorter 33-yard line. So a loss of 8, and West Alabama will be forced to burn their last timeout with 18 and a half seconds left. And so now that changes things. You've got a situation where your starting field goal kicker is pretty much on the shelf today. He can be used in an emergency situation, but I don't know that this is the time to use him, given that you've got 18 and a half seconds to try and go 33 yards. You're out of timeouts, and so you've got to either get first downs to stop the clock till you can get to the line of scrimmage, or you've got to hit the sidelines.
Yeah, in West Alabama, obviously they can do those types of things. Got a great receiving core. You've got Jamoris McMillan and Bailey Blanchard, some of those guys that can get those first downs and sideline plays for you as well.
UWA Athletic Department would like to thank and recognize the following sponsors of Tiger Athletics: Meridian Coca-Cola, Plaza Golf of Demopolis, WTOK-TV in Meridian, and Regions Bank. Thank you for your generous support of Tiger Athletics. 18 and a half seconds left in this first half. West Alabama leading 13-0. They have the ball second and long at the shorter 33-yard line. No timeouts remaining. McDaniels dumps it off to Smith across the 35, the 30. He will get out of bounds across the 25, is hit late, and that will prompt a penalty flag against Shorter. And so Shorter trying to help out West Alabama. That will be a half the distance to the goal penalty. Will move it probably around the 12-yard line where West Alabama will have 11.9 seconds. And it is a late hit out of bounds. Half the distance, it'll be a first down for West Alabama, but more importantly, they will have it deep in Shorter territory. They'll mark it at the 12 with 12 seconds remaining. So from here, you got two shots to the end zone.
The call is going to go against Jeffrey Brewer, and his teammates and coaches definitely not happy with that late hit as they're going to call a timeout. It's going to be a timeout here. We got 12 seconds remaining, 13-0 your score.
So Shorter elects to call the timeout and regroup. As looking across the far sideline, you can see that there is an animated discussion going on. One of the coaches is having to be held back a little bit. I think he was upset at his player for that penalty, and that really changed things. West Alabama would have had it first down and 10 at the Shorter 24-yard line with 12 seconds, but now they have got it first and 10 at the Shorter 12. You know, when you're playing from 24 yards out, those type of plays take more time to develop. You know you're going to have one, possibly two from that distance, but going at it from the 12-yard line, shorter plays take less time, and so clearly West Alabama will easily have time to run two plays, two shots to the end zone, unless they want to try Zach Gaines on a short field goal. So 11.9 seconds remaining first half. West Alabama leading 13-0. McDaniels looking to throw towards the end zone, trying to back shoulder fade to Blanchard. The timing was off on that one. By the time Blanchard turned around, the ball had already sailed past him. So 8.3 seconds, that play took 3.6, so a possibility that West Alabama still has time for two more plays if they are quickly developing plays. McDaniels will go empty backfield, three receivers left, two to the right. Shorter with seven guys at the 2-yard line or in the end zone. McDaniels moving up in the pocket, flips it to Quay Boyd in the end zone. Is it caught? You betcha. Quay Boyd with a 12-yard touchdown reception. That time, McDaniels did the same thing, threw it up in the air, betting on his guy, Quay Boyd, being able to bring it down, and that time he did for the 12-yard touchdown reception.
Well, Jack McDaniels was able to get out of harm's way, and then he just kind of flips it up there to the big guy, and Quay Boyd jumps up, brings it down for the touchdown. West Alabama 19, Shorter Hawks nothing with the PAT forthcoming. Bailey Blanchard in to hold. You got the snap is good. The hold is down. The kick is up, and it is through the upright. So West Alabama tacks on another one here with 2.4 remaining here. 20-0 your score at homecoming. On your station for West Alabama football, ESPN 104.9.
What is it about UWA? Is it the beauty of her campus? The feeling of being just the right size? World class, without classes big enough for the world. Is it the warmth of her people? They say there's something about this place. Maybe it's because this place feels like home. On campus or online. The University of West Alabama.
The Hawks. It'll be a squib kick that will go out of bounds at the Shorter 25-yard line. So Shorter will take over first down and 10 at their 35. They only have 2.4 seconds remaining and only one timeout, so only a chance for one play here for the Hawks.
West Alabama scoring drive covered 64 yards. It took 10 plays and took a minute 45 off, and they were able to get it into the end zone. McDaniels to Boyd, and then Zach Gaines was able to put it through for the PAT to extend the lead. West Alabama leading 20-0 here with 2 seconds and some change here at homecoming.
UWA Athletic Department would like to thank and recognize the following sponsors of Tiger Athletics: Adidas, St. Vincent's Healthcare System, Little Caesars, and Dixie Country Radio. Thank you for your generous support of Tiger Athletics. Shorter, on the final play, barring a penalty of the first half, will send 3 receivers left, 1 to the right. The Tigers have a safety man all the way back at their own 30-yard line. This play will be blown dead before it can get started. Our referee, Eddie Smith, with the call. That was a false start on Shorter. That will back them up to their 30. It'll be first down and 15, 2.4 ticks remaining. Now Shorter will get into a kneel-down situation, it appears. Pullum will kneel it, and the final second goes off the clock of the first half. So after one half here in Livingston, on homecoming, West Alabama leads Shorter 20-0. You're listening to West Alabama Football, ESPN 104.9, ESPN1049.com.
NCAA Division II community engagement is an initiative at all 25 national championships because student-athletes want to give back while competing for a national title. Over the course of the year, Division II student-athletes have an opportunity to leave a lasting impression in local communities throughout the country. Whether Division II student-athletes are volunteering at hospitals, schools, after-school care programs, foster homes, or retirement villages, they make a difference in the lives of others. In Division II, we rise to the opportunity and make community engagement ours.
'52 national championships. More than 600 annual graduates. Thousands of lives changed. The Gulf South Conference.
In NCAA Division II, student-athletes leave a lasting impression on their communities. That's because Division II student-athletes want to make a difference and truly be part of their surrounding communities. Through community engagement, thousands of student-athletes from various backgrounds interact with community members who view them as role models. This interaction leaves a positive and perhaps even life-changing impression on all those involved. In Division II, we rise to the opportunity and make community engagement ours.
There were 10 first downs in that first half, 22 carries for 34 yards, 97 passing yards, 38 plays, 131 total yards of offense. 2 kick returns for 37 yards and an interception for 21 yards. 3 punts for an average of 42 yards. They fumbled once and lost it. 3 penalties for 31 yards. They have had the ball the majority of the first halftime possession, 19 minutes and 17 seconds. 5 of 10 on third down. Did not convert their only try on fourth down. They have not yet been to the red zone. And now for the Tigers. Well, 20 points in the first half. They had 14 first downs. 14 carries, 115 yards, 156 yards through the air, 35 plays total, 271 yards of offense. Two punt returns for 23 yards. They've punted once, and that only went 28 yards, a low for Zach Gaines. One penalty for 15 yards. Time possession, 10 minutes and 43 seconds. They are 3 of 6 on third down. Did not convert their only one fourth down attempt, and they are 2 for 2 on the Tigers in the red zone. Let's go over the scoring plays. Tigers, it's been, you know, all UWA has got on the board in the first quarter, 4 minutes and 43 seconds to go. Derek Underwood took a 5-yard run. Zach Gaines missed the PAT. That made it 6-0. Then in the second quarter, the Tigers found the scoreboard again. 10 minutes on the clock. James Smith went 55 yards. Zach Gaines did hit the PAT that time. That kept a two-play 66-yard drive. It was a 24-second drive, and it made it 13-0. West Alabama. And then just right before the half, 2 seconds left, Quay Boy caught a 12-yard pass from Jack McDaniels. He was about quintuple covered right in the middle of the end zone, and he got it done. Zach Gaines hit the PAT. That was a 10-play, 64-yard drive. Went in a minute and 45 seconds, and it put the Tigers up 20-0. That's what we have now, 20-0 here in Livingston. We're going to keep the halftime show running on the YouTube, but we'll take a quick break here since it is homecoming. We'll let the folks on YouTube see what's going on, but we'll take a radio break, pay some bills, and we come back. We'll talk about individual performance right here. It's UWA Halftime Show. I'm Nicholas Finch on ESPN 104.9. Welcome back to Livingston, Alabama. Still halftime here, about 14 minutes to go until halftime is over. We're about one more introduction away from finding out who will be the 2019 UWA homecoming queen. But here in the football game, it's a 20-0 lead for the Tigers. So let's go over some individual stats. We'll start with the visitors as usual. We'll start with Shorter. Tupac Lanier, 12 carries, 46 yards. Longest run of 12 yards. He's the leading rusher. Anemis Dennis, he has a carry for 4 yards. And Tyler Pullum is kind of taking 2 carries. He's gone backwards for -6 yards. Pullum, the quarterback, is 9 of 16 through the air, 97 yards. He's been sacked twice. Receiving, Christian Da Silva leading, 2 receptions, 19 yards. Cameron King, 2 receptions, 19 yards. Tupac Lanier, 2 receptions, 10 yards. Elijah Gilbert, 1 reception and 26 yards. And we'll pause quick, right second. Let's see who won queen. I think she's thinking. She said Micaiah Hall will be the 2019 homecoming queen. So congrats to her. I think I showed up just right in time so we can hear it announced. Back to Shorter. Brett Barton-Whipper, 3 punts, 126 yards, an average of 42 yards. His longest was 46 yards. Jeffrey Brewer Jr., 2 kick returns for 37 yards. And then on defense, Brewer Jr. is 5 total tackles, 4 unassisted. Bruce Guyton Jr., 3 total tackles, all unassisted. Tyshawn Jackson, 3 tackles, 2 unassisted. He has a tackle for loss. And Terrence Snelling, 2 unassisted tackles. Now let's look at West Alabama. James Smith with 4 rushes for 64 yards and a touchdown. He had that big 55-yard long carry. Demetrius Battle, 2 carries, 35 yards. Derek Underwood, 6 carries, 22 yards and a score as well. Jack Daniels, 2 carries, negative 6 yards. McDaniels through the air, 15 completions, 21 attempts, 1 INT, 156 yards and a touchdown. And he's been sacked once. Receiving, Bailey Blanchard, 4 receptions, 47 yards. Derek Underwood, 3 receptions, 23 yards. Quay Boyd, 2 receptions for 32 yards. And Jamarius McMillan, 2 receptions for 19 yards. Zach Gaines, only 1 punt. Didn't have to punt it far, 28 yards. And it was inside the 20 as a result of it. Punt return, Sid Thurman, 2 returns for 23 yards. No kick returns for West Alabama so far, although they will have a kick return to start the second half as they'll receive the ball and deferred to the second half after winning a toss. Jordan Grady, the leading tackler, 5 total tackles, all unassisted. He has 1 for loss. Jordan Jones, 5 tackles, 2 unassisted, 3 assisted. He also has a tackle for loss. Josh Hatcher with 4 tackles, all unassisted. And Tavarius Hutchison with 3 tackles, 2 of which were unassisted. We'll take one more break, and when we come back, we'll talk about trends from the first half and what the Tigers need to do to make sure this one stays with as big a gap as it is. 20-0 is your score here at the half. I'm Nicholas Finch. We'll take a break and come back with more of the Halftime Show here on ESPN 104.9 and YouTube.
Being a champion takes more than talent, more than the perfect pass, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the spirit to always push harder, the ability to overcome any hurdle, and the fire to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create. And the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
Band plays. It's a 20-0 lead here for the Tigers here at halftime, about 9 minutes to go. Normally, this is where I have Coach Axon in. We talk shop about what the Tigers need to do to maintain.
52 national championships. 600 annual graduates. Thousands of lives changed. The Gulf South Conference.
After a heartbreaking loss last week to North Greenville, last second field goal to give the Crusaders a win here. This is a very important win for the Tigers, not just for their confidence, but also with it being homecoming. You want to send all the alumni and all the friends that are in town, you want to send them home happy. And, you know, seeing all types of familiar faces here in Tiger Stadium. One last break, 8 minutes to go until the start of the second half. I'm Nicholas Finch. This is UWA Football on ESPN 104.9. Thank you. Welcome back to the halftime show. About 6 minutes to go until the start of the second half. I'm joined now by the coach, Will Atkinson. Coach, before you came in, I was telling the people at home or watching on YouTube that, you know, when you have a 20-0 lead here at the half, it's hard to find something to complain about or find something to say, hey, what do the Tigers need to do in the second half to be better? But you are a little bit more of an expert than me, so I'm going to ask you, what differences can the Tigers make here?
First of all, Nick, I would never claim to be an expert on absolutely anything unless it might be. I'm really good at eating pizza and hamburgers, so I would maybe go into that category. But from the football standpoint, you know, the thing that I liked early on was the defense really came out and they played with a lot of enthusiasm. They seemed really jacked up and was really just kind of buzzing around the football. One of the things that I'd like to see them be able to do more of in the second half is finish drives. You know, I know with the injury that we've gotten to our kicking game and some of the other things that's kind of hampered some of our options. But, you know, we don't need to just kind of keep chalking that up to, well, this is our situation. You know, I'd love to see the offense be able to, you know, finish some drives. And, you know, if the defense could come out, something that we haven't done much all year, we haven't created a lot of turnovers. We created one, you know, in the first half. I'd like to see them come out, kind of flex their muscles a little bit and continue to kind of get everything polished up, because I don't want to get too far ahead of today. But if we do what we're supposed to today, we got to travel for a big game next week to Delta State. So right now, ironing out those kind of imperfections and getting ready and continuing to prepare for next week, I think will be big for us in this second half.
Again, just something you can't complain about. I mean, the offense has 271 total yards in the first half and 35 plays, but they've only had the ball for 10 minutes and 43 seconds, while Shorter had it for 19-17. So in the second half, what would you like to see from the offense?
From our offense is just, you know, continue to move the football and create opportunities. And from the defense, if we could just figure out a way not to give up the big play. You know, I mean, we've done really good at times, but even, you know, through the games before today, the first five games, we have a tendency to give up a big play, and I'd really like to see them just kind of tighten the screws a little bit and not give up the big play.
Absolutely. And then just finally, Jack McDaniels, 15 of 21, 156 yards and a touchdown. What have you seen from him specifically that you've liked in this first half?
What I have liked is he's been able to avoid some pressure, because the offensive front has done a good job of creating some time. But when they haven't, he's been able to, you know, avoid duress. But what I would like to see a little bit better, he's thrown a couple of balls to me that are a little iffy, maybe ill-advised. So just really, you know, trying to make something out of nothing. You know, the ball that when he tried to go to Quay Boyd, he had two guys on him. It just gets tipped up and for the interception. So just making a little bit better decisions. But, you know, I think he's a solid football player. And, you know, I'd just like to see them continue to come out here in this second half and, you know, pick up where we left off.
All right, one last thing before I get out of here. I've plugged it every single home game, and I'll do it one more time. If you haven't yet, please subscribe to my podcast, the True Comedy Podcast, hosted with Kirsten Cunningham. Comes out new episodes every Tuesday. You can subscribe on any major podcast source, Google Podcasts, Apple Podcasts, Spotify, anything you can think of, it's there. And just we were talking about last night. You've listened to a few episodes.
So. I've listened to a couple episodes. I enjoyed it. It's more meaningful to me because I know the guys that are sitting there enjoying it, and I feel like I could be sitting there watching this unfold. So definitely it's something worth kind of tuning into if you want a good laugh.
So absolutely, I appreciate you.
No sweat, man.
All right, 2 minutes to go until the second half. I'm getting out of here. When we come back, it'll be Robert Upchurch and Will Atkinson. This has been the halftime show here at UWA Football Tiger Stadium. 20-0 lead for the Tigers at the half. ESPN 104.9.
Yes.
back in Tiger Stadium for second half action between West Alabama and Shorter. West Alabama with the 20-0 halftime advantage. UWA will receive the kick to start the second half. West Alabama is second in the conference in kickoff return yards at 23.1 yards per return. And Christian Salisbury leads the GSC in kickoff returns, averaging just over 24 yards per return. So hopefully Salisbury will get a chance to electrify this homecoming crowd with a kickoff return here. Will, pretty good first half by the Tigers, doing what they needed to do. Still aren't clicking on all cylinders, but it's a good start in that direction.
Yeah, I would agree with that. You know, there's definitely some things that they can continue to iron out, and I think they will do that throughout this half right here. But, you know, there's some positives as well. They've limited their penalties. You know, the defense overall has done a pretty good job, but they've still got to avoid giving up that big play. And, you know, I'm just excited to see where this second half takes us here as West Alabama is going to get the first possession here as they lead 20-0 at homecoming here as we get ready to get this second half underway.
Borden Werper will kick it deep to Salisbury and Patrick McGee. Salisbury will get a chance on the return from his five. Takes it up the far hash, 15, 20. He's got a crease at 25, 30. Cuts it outside to the 40. Cuts it back inside across midfield. So a terrific job by Christian Salisbury getting it into Shorter territory all the way to the Hawks' 48-yard line. That will be a 47-yard return, so that will help Salisbury's average, already leading the conference in return yards per return. And so a great job by Salisbury on that.
Raekwon Birch kind of had to haul him down from behind as he was slowed up by Borden Werper, but he was able to get it across midfield, so West Alabama will be inside the Hawks territory. First down and 10 from the Hawks 48.
McDaniels with the hard count. Shorter flinches but does not jump. McDaniels checks the play with the sideline. Now he will get it, hand off to James Smith around the left side. Smith able to make one man miss, cuts it to the outside, now back to the inside before eventually getting pushed out of bounds at the Shorter 38-yard line. It should be good for a West Alabama first down, and it is.
Nice job right there by West Alabama. Was able to move the chains on first down, and they're moving pretty quickly here as McDaniel brings them to the line.
Jack will have two receivers right, one to the left. It'll be a handoff again to Smith, this time up the middle, reaches the 35 and then is pushed backwards. So Smith this time picks up 2 yards after getting 10 on the previous carry.
Xavier Robinson will be credited with the tackle. After the short gain by Smith, it'll bring up second down. It'll be about 8 yards. The ball is spotted on the Shorter 35-yard line as Jack McDaniels deploys two wide receivers to the far side, one here to the near side. That'll be Martin.
James Smith stays in at running back. He will be in pistol formation behind McDaniels. Quay Boyd will be the tight end to the left side of the formation. Hand off to Smith. This time wants to cut it to the right but has to go up the middle. Again, only about 2 yards on the carry. It'll bring up a third down and 6 for the Tigers on the opening possession of the second half. West Alabama leading Shorter 20-0.
Seventh carry of the afternoon for Smith, as he's gotten the majority of the touches here today. Third down for West Alabama. Jack McDaniels looking to the sideline to get the call. You're going to have Martin and Salisbury here to the near side with Quay Boyd to the end, and that'll be Bailey Blanchard on the numbers to the far side.
McDaniels will move Smith from a pistol formation into a shotgun formation to his left. Jack looking to throw, getting pressure, steps up in the pocket, but will be sacked back at the Shorter 41.5-yard line. So a loss of 8 on that sack. McDaniels had time to throw, moved up in the pocket, and finally the Shorter rush was able to get to McDaniels.
Credit Xavier Robinson and Christian James Lattimore by getting the pressure right there, is basically West Alabama's running back Smith had two guys to block, and he could only get his hands and body in front of one, and they're going to be credited with a sack. It'll be Zach Gaines back to punt. He'll be standing at his own 45-yard line with a return man for shorter standing at his own 10.
It'll be an end-over-end punt by Gaines, trying to pin shorter deep, and does an incredible job. It will be downed at the shorter 3-yard line. Terrific job by Zach Gaines, not only to angle it towards that corner, but also to put enough height on it to allow his coverage unit to get down there and kill it at the 3-yard line.
Special team Xavier Williamson was able to get down there, and he's able to get it before it bounds into the end zone. So it'll be first down and 10, shorter working from their own 3-yard line with 12:24 remaining here in this third quarter. 20-0 your score in favor of the Tigers.
Pullum will have one receiver left, three to the right, a running back to his right is Tupac Lanier. Pullum looks to the sideline, gets the play. Now he will relay it to the offensive line. 10 on the play clock. Pullum claps, gets it, hands off to Lanier along the left end. Nothing much doing. Lanier will get to the 5-yard line. So it'll be a pickup of 2 on first down for the Hawks.
2 tough yards right there, as West Alabama's defensive front just kind of closed up the gap before there was anything really going. So that'll bring up second down for the Hawks, still within the shadow of their own goal post. 12 minutes remaining in the third quarter.
Shorter sends one receiver out, Christian Da Silva. Tight end checks in for the Hawks. He will line up on the left side of the formation. Pullum wants to throw on second down. Quick in route is complete out across the 10 up to the 15-yard line. Be a pickup of 10 on second and 8 and a shorter first down.
He was able to get it out to his wide receiver. That's going to be number 80, Devin Price. He's a freshman out of Somerville, Georgia. Something we didn't mention, as a very young team, this shorter ball club. They've got 44 players listed on their depth chart that's either freshmen or sophomores, compared to West Alabama with just 9.
So these young Hawks will get to the line. First down, handoff up the middle. Not much doing there. Pickup of only about a yard and a half for Trevor Smith, the running back. Smith went up the middle. Not much of a hole created by this shorter offensive line. The front 7 of the Tigers able to smell that one and stop Smith before he could get going. So it'll make it 2nd and 8, 10:40 remaining third quarter, 20-0 West Alabama leading shorter. Pullum will have 2 receivers left, an H-back to the left, 1 receiver right. Hand off to Smith up the middle. A little bit more room this time as Smith will fight forward to the 20. Only pick up another 2.5 yards. So it's going to make it 3rd down and about 5 yards for the Hawks.
Hutchinson and Proctor in on a stop for West Alabama. So the defense trying to get another stop here as this drive started on the shorter, that's about 2 to 3 yard line there. So they've given themselves a little bit of room to work with, but the defense right here wanting to shut it down on third down.
4 receivers left, 1 to the right, empty backfield for Pullum. Pullum wants to loft it to his receiver, Devin Price. Pass is incomplete. There was man coverage over there. Shorter wanting a penalty flag, not getting it. So it's going to bring up 4th down for the Hawks.
Intended receiver for Shorter was the wide receiver 80, Devin Price. But in coverage for West Alabama was number 27, Trey Elston. Just kind of mirroring him step for step right there as the ball falls incomplete. And that'll bring out the punting unit, a name that we've called out several times this afternoon, Barton Werper. He will be doing the punting, and Sid Thurman stands at his own 48-yard line near hash.
Tigers should get good field position out of this. Barton Werper's punt is a high spiral that will send Thurman back to his 35. He reverses field to his 25, now tries to cut up the middle, not much doing. He will be tackled at the West Alabama 28-yard line. So right there, Thurman hurting himself going back that far, really never able to recover from it. So West Alabama, in what should have been good field position, will start all the way back at their 28-yard line.
It was really interesting right there as Barton Werper, as he's able to get a high spiraling punt, but his foot just completely slipped out from underneath him. It looked like the old cartoons where you step on a banana peel and he flies out. But West Alabama's offense will take over. First down and 10. They'll be working from their own 28.
McDaniels quick pitch to James Smith along right end, tries to cut outside and does. He's at the 40, he's at midfield. He leaves everybody in the dust at the 30, 20, 10, and tripped up at the 5-yard line of Shorter. James Smith, a quick pitch, and for the second time today, all he needed was a little crease to get that corner, and then once he gets to the corner, he is a hard man to bring down. He was tripped up from behind inside the Shorter 10. They will mark it down at the 6, maybe the 7-yard line. West Alabama will have it first and goal. Handoff Smith up the middle, runs into his own man, is able to recover and get to the 5. So it'll be a pickup of 2 on first and goal.
Smith was tripped up by Jeffrey Brewer Jr. And not a pretty play, but a touchdown-saving play nonetheless as he made the sideline and had the end zone in his sights as West Alabama is going to be looking down. At a second and goal, they'll be working from about their own 5-yard line.
Smith out, Demetrius Battle in. Handoff Battle up the middle, cuts it to his right, now moves towards the goal line, will be brought down inside the 2, maybe give him the 1-yard line. It'll be third and goal from the Shorter 1.
Battle took it right to the point of attack and just nothing going on, so he bounces it out just to the right, and he's able to get in behind a couple of those big linemen. He makes positive yardage, but it's going to bring up third down and goal. They'll be working from, it looks like the ball's going to be spotted on about the 1.5-yard line as the offense kind of huddles right there as Jack Murphy breaks the huddle. He'll have Battle in the, Jack McDaniel, and has Battle in the backfield.
Extra lineman and tight end into the game. Handoff Battle up the middle, hits 2 Shorter defenders, carries them into the end zone. Delayed call. Thought for sure Battle had gotten into the end zone. No signal yet. They're going to mark him down inside the 1.
Wow.
It looked from here that Battle had gotten into the end zone, and after he broke the plane, was then pushed back. But they do not give him the touchdown. They will mark it down just shy of the goal line, so it'll make it fourth and goal from inside the Shorter 1. West Alabama going for it, and rightfully so. McDaniels will have Battle offset to his right. Handoff Battle up the middle, not going to stop him this time. Demetrius Battle from 1 yard out for the West Alabama touchdown.
Nice job right there by the offensive line. They just kind of gave him the charge that they needed. And I'm like you, Robert, it looked like the play just prior that Battle was going to be able to get the touchdown nod, but they did not give it to him. But there was no doubt about that as Battle records his 5th touchdown of the year. Zach Gaines on to attempt the PAT.
Gaines' kick is up, and it is good. And so with 6:57 remaining, third quarter, West Alabama extends their lead 27-0 over Shorter. You're listening to West Alabama Football, ESPN 104.9, ESPN104.9.com.
What is it about UWA? Is it the beauty of her campus? The feeling of being just the right size? World class, without classes big enough for the world? Is it the warmth of her people? They say there's something about this place. Maybe it's because this place feels like home. On campus or online, the University of West Alabama.
Dodge Chrysler Jeep of Meridian is dedicated to ensuring your auto process is a smooth and stress-free one, regardless of whether you're shopping online or on-site. They provide comprehensive sales, purchase, finance, and maintenance assistance. Stop by and pick the ride of your future. Johnson Dodge Chrysler Jeep, a proud sponsor of UWA Athletics. Zach Gaines has it teed up at the 35, getting ready to kick it deep to the shorter Hawks. Gaines checks to his left, now to his right. Kick will be a high end-over-end kick, be fielded by Fields at the 5. He juggles it, has it in, cuts it to the left, now tries to get to the left sideline, cannot before he is tripped up right at the 20-yard line. Another nice job of coverage by this UWA special teams unit.
Patrick McGee and company in on the special team stop for West Alabama as Fields tried to get to the numbers on the far side and get it turned upfield, but the defensive unit, a special teams unit rather, doing a great job right there as they are set to defend this first down and 10 from their shorter 20 as West Alabama leads 27-0 here with 6:49 remaining in the third quarter.
Tyler Pullum back out there at quarterback. Two receivers right, one to the left, a running back to his right in shotgun formation. Pullum, quick throw into the slot on the left side. Pass will reach the shorter 28-yard line. So it'll be a pickup of 8, pass complete to Andrew Warren, the sophomore wide receiver. Trey Elston was in on the tackle, and he's slow to get up. In fact, he goes down to the turf, looked like he was holding his right hand or arm. Don't know if he got it fallen on or whether he got it kind of sandwiched in between the receiver and the other Tigers who were over there making the tackle. UWA Athletic Department would like to thank and recognize the following sponsors of Tiger Athletics: Roebuck Landing, Savory Solutions, and ATI Sports Medicine. Thank you for your generous support of Tiger Athletics. 6:29 remaining third quarter, West Alabama leading shorter 27-0. And Will, this is the point of the games in the past couple of weeks where West Alabama has gotten a lead, it feels comfortable, and then it seems like West Alabama takes their foot off the gas and lets the other team back in. I know Coach Gilliland right now wants to see that killer instinct take over for the Tigers as Elston makes his way off the field.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. You know, it's West Alabama has been in control, but they don't need to, as you say, take their foot off the gas right now. They need to be able to, you know, just finish and play it out. You know, as Elston comes to the sideline, it looked like he was favoring maybe a shoulder or something.
Pullum fakes the quick throw, now hits a slant underneath. Pass is complete, will be good enough for a first down. Will actually get all the way out to the shorter 47-yard line. Nice pass there by Pullum. Was able to complete that slant underneath for good yardage. So shorter will have it first and 10 at the Hawks 47-yard line. Under 6 minutes, third quarter, 27-0 West Alabama.
Shorter on the afternoon, getting 8 different receivers into the mix as Pullum surveys the scene here on first down.
Two receivers either way. Pullum will put it in the air again, but not this time. He will be brought down in the backfield by Andreas Lilly in on the sack. Pullum was looking to hit a man running deep, but the West Alabama front four did not let him have the time as Lilly was able to bust in there and bring Pullum down for the sack.
Second sack of the year for Lilly as he's able to get into the backfield in a hurry right there, as the offensive line didn't have anything for the big defensive lineman there. It's going to be second down and long as we hit the 5-minute mark of the third quarter.
Pullum looking to throw. Quick screen pass up underneath. Receiver will be brought down at the 42. Andrew Warren on the reception. Pickup of only about 2.5 on the play. So third and long four shorter.
Warren quickly becoming a favorite target here for Pullum as he's caught three passes here in this series as the West Alabama defense is looking to get a stop here on third and long.
Tight end Brock Jackson checks out. Christian DeSilva, the wide receiver, checks in. So Shorter will have two receivers either way, running back in the backfield to Pullum's right. Pullum looking to throw on third and long, getting pressure again, escapes it, able to throw downfield. Pass is complete to Cameron King. It will get into Tiger territory, but it'll be short of the first down.
King's third catch of the afternoon, and a lot of pressure being put on Pullum right there as he's able to avoid the sack. He's able to unload it and get it to King, but not enough to move the chains for the Hawks. So that'll bring out Barton Werper once again. And Sid Thurman will go back to field this punt. He'll be on the far hash, his heels on his own 10-yard line.
Shorter offense wanting to go for it, fourth and four at the Tiger 48, but they are overruled by their head coach who elects to punt. Thurman will make the fair catch at the West Alabama 12-yard line. So UWA will take over first and 10 from their own 12, 3:29 remaining third quarter, leading Shorter 27-0.
On the afternoon, Jack McDaniels, 15 of 21 for 156 yards for West Alabama. He's able to get one touchdown as he found Quay Boyd there in the end zone. He's got it to six different receivers as he trots out onto the field, bringing his offense with him. They'll be looking at a first down and 10 from their own 12-yard line.
McDaniels will have Battle in at running back behind him, pistol formation, two receivers to the right, one to the left. Handoff Battle up the middle, not much doing up the middle, so he cuts it to his left, has a little bit of a seam, will get out across the 20. So a nice job right there by Battle, who, given his size, most people think of him as really just a straight-ahead runner. That time, nothing doing up the middle, was able to cut it out to the left and pick up around 8-9 yards. This play will be blown dead before West Alabama can get the snap off. So West Alabama flagged for a false start. That one will go against Carl Dyer, the center. Dyer flinched right before he snapped it, drawing the flag. McDaniels will empty the backfield, sends Battle as a receiver to the right side. Three receivers right, two to the left. Jack looking to throw, got time, looking to go deep, has Blanchard open at midfield, pass is complete. Blanchard being held up by two Hawks will finally be wrestled down at the Shorter 45-yard line. So a pickup of 40 yards on the reception by Blanchard. Tigers quickly up to the line of scrimmage. Salisbury checks out. Deion Hill into the game. Tyreek Martin will be a receiver to the left-hand side of the formation as well. Handoff, Battle up the middle, being held up by the ankle, still able to fall forward for a pickup of three down to the Shorter 42-yard line.
Going back to that Bailey Blanchard reception, he was wide open, and if Jack McDaniel had just a little bit more arm right there and can hit him in stride and he doesn't have to check up, he might have been able to take that one to the house. But a great job right there by the West Alabama offense to pick up the first down, get it across midfield, and they're looking at a second down and 8 from the Shorter Hawks 42.
Battle out, Smith in at running back, Blanchard in motion. Jack looking to throw, dumps it off to Smith on the right flat. Smith cuts it up across the 40. Nice spin move. Will have enough for the West Alabama first down. Terrific catch by James Smith. Jack kind of overthrew him. Smith had to do an over-the-shoulder grab, then was able to keep his feet as he cut up the sideline enough to get the first down for the Tigers.
I know this is not a baseball season, but it's a Willie Mays type catch right there is he's able to get the first down. West Alabama, first down and 10 from the Hawks 34.
Fake the handoff to Smith. They hit Boyd over the middle. Quay is able to take it down to the shorter 17-yard line, and that's what a running game will do right there. They fake the handoff to Smith. It sucked in the linebackers, and then Jack was able to throw to a wide-open Quay Boyd over the middle for another Tiger first down.
Three catches for Boyd on the afternoon as the West Alabama offense is clicking on all cylinders. First down and 10 from the 17 of the Hawks.
Handoff battle up the middle. 15 bounces off one man. Will get down to the 12 and a half. And you can see that's the second or third time in a row Battle gets it. One of the Hawks will hit him around the numbers, and then they just slide down and hold on for dear life until somebody else can come and help bring down the big bruising running back.
Yeah,
it'll be a pickup of around four on the play as we're under 20 seconds remaining here in the third quarter. McDaniels hands off once again to Battle. This time the Hawks are able to bring him down after only a gain of about a yard and a half on what will be the final play of the third quarter. So West Alabama will go into the fourth, leading shorter 27-0. You're listening to West Alabama Football, ESPN 1049, ESPN1049.com.
What is it about UWA? Is it the beauty of her campus? The feeling of being just the right size? World class, without classes big enough for the world. Is it the warmth of her people? They say there's something about this place. Maybe it's because this place feels like home. On campus or online. The University of West Alabama.
Being a champion takes more than talent, more than the perfect pass, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the spirit to always push harder, the ability to overcome any hurdle, and the fire to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create. And the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
In NCAA Division II, student athletes leave a lasting impression on their communities. That's because Division II student-athletes want to make a difference and truly be part of their surrounding communities. Through community engagement, thousands of student-athletes from various backgrounds interact with community members who view them as role models. This interaction leaves a positive and perhaps even life-changing impression on all those involved. In Division II, we rise to the opportunity and make community engagement ours.
Robert Upchurch, Will Atkinson here, Tiger Stadium, heading to the fourth quarter. West Alabama leading shorter, 27-0, threatening to score again. They have it third down and six from the shorter 12-yard line. McDaniels will send two receivers right, one to the left. Quay Boyd, the tight end, in line to the left side of the formation. Demetrius Battle, the running back, behind Jack. Jack looking to throw, trying to find Blanchard. Has him sliding, diving, touchdown, Bailey Blanchard. 12-yard connection, Jack McDaniels to Bailey Blanchard.
Nice job right there by Jack McDaniel, just being really patient for Blanchard to get the position on the defender as he's able to deliver a strike. Blanchard kind of slides under it and is able to corral that one in for the score. He's going to come in to hold as Zach Gaines will be on to attempt the PAT for West Alabama.
High snap, Blanchard gets it down. An ugly kick, but it goes over the crossbar and through. Maybe one of the ugliest PATs that you will ever see in your life, but it counts just the same. And so 14:54 remaining in the game. West Alabama now leads shorter 34-0.
I would love to be able to paint a picture on that PAT right there, but, to tell you it was ugly would be probably giving it a little bit more credit than it deserves. But it kind of bloops over, and West Alabama is able to extend the lead. And, Robert, West Alabama seems to be clicking a little bit right here.
West Alabama's offense has continued to really get it into the hands of their playmakers. We've talked about it a number of times this season. All Jack McDaniels has to do is distribute the ball to the playmakers he has around him. Has three running backs who are averaging at least 4.5 yards a carry. Then he's got receivers, Tyreek Martin, Christian Salisbury, Bailey Blanchard, and then he's got an All-American at tight end in Quay Boyd. And today, for the first time in a couple of weeks, you see that confidence coming back to Jack, and he has the confidence to deliver it to the different playmakers right there, getting it to Bailey Blanchard. And when you've got players like Blanchard, like that last throw was a perfect example, it doesn't have to be a perfect throw. Bailey is able to go down, make a sliding catch for the touchdown as Gaines will kick it off to Shorter. High end-over-end kick that will be fielded at the 18 by the Hawks. They fumble. West Alabama down on the pile. They say they have it. They come out with it. West Alabama with the fumble recovery. You had Deontay Crockett, the backup linebacker, with the fumble recovery. Great job by the kickoff coverage unit once again. It was a short kick. West Alabama able to get down, cover the kick, deliver a hard hit, and then come up with the fumble recovery. So after scoring just seconds ago and taking the lead 34-0, West Alabama gets the turnover and will set up shop first down and 10 somewhere around the 28-29-yard line whenever they are able to get things finally set.
Yeah, in all the excitement of the West Alabama turnover, a Shorter Hawk is down. He's being tended to by his athletic training staff. Hard to see from here what that number is, but they are huddled around him, and hopefully he's okay.
Nahiola Credit Union has been proudly serving its members since 1959. With branches in Livingston, Demopolis, Butler, and Pennington, Nahiola is the bridge to all of your financial needs, from checking, savings, loan services, and much more, including serving as a proud sponsor of UWA Athletics. Nahiola Credit Union, simple. And Will, so far today, it has been just what West Alabama needed. They needed to get that confidence back. You've seen it in all phases of the game. Offense, defense, and special teams have really been clicking. The offense has gotten rolling, especially here third quarter. And the defense so far through three quarters plus, pitching a shutout.
Yeah, Jack McDaniels with two touchdown passes on the afternoon. He's been 19 of 25. He has the interception, but he's been able to find six different receivers. Bailey Blanchard leading the way with six catches, but you got Boyd Smith and Underwood each with three catches, and McMillan and Martin with two catches of their own. So you talked about earlier the playmakers that he has around him. He's definitely made work of that. And then you've got James Smith, Demetrius Battle, and Derek Underwood that have done a pretty darn good job of running the football. Smith over 100 yards. Heck, he's over 145 yards on the afternoon already.
He will get the handoff on first down. Up the middle is hit hard, but able to keep those feet moving down to the 25-yard line. So it'll be a pickup of four for the Tigers on first down.
That's his 10th carry of the afternoon. He's averaging somewhere around 15 yards a carry after a couple of big runs, with one long run of 65 yards here. West Alabama's looking at a second down and six.
Hill, the receiver, goes in motion from the right to the left. They fake the toss to Smith. McDaniels will keep it around right end, will be tackled at the 20-yard line. There is a penalty flag thrown, likely in the area where you would expect to see a hold.
West Alabama overall today has done a pretty good job with the penalties. If this does indeed go against West Alabama, it'll only be the third penalty of the afternoon, something that the Tigers have struggled with. And that will be a holding against West Alabama, so that'll bring the chains back. They'll set the ball. It'll be at about the Shorter 35-yard line. So it'll be second down and long for West Alabama. It's Jack McDaniel. He brings his offense out onto the line. He's going to deploy one wide receiver to the near side. That's McMillan. And three wide receivers to the far side with Battle in the backfield.
McDaniels will fake the handoff to Battle, comes this way towards McMillan, and nearly intercepted by Caleb Winton. Check that. Kevin Zachary, the junior outside linebacker, he had drifted over in that area. McDaniels never saw him. And frankly, Zachary should have intercepted that pass.
Absolutely. I mean, it hit him right in the hands, and he just wasn't able to bring that one in. So third down and long for West Alabama. Jack McDaniels in shotgun with Battle behind him.
McDaniels surveying the defense, will move Battle to his right. Jack wants to throw, moving around in the pocket, now delivers it across the middle towards McMillan. Nice play by Shorter to knock that one down. In coverage for the Hawks was Nehemiah Reddish. He was able to get just enough around McMillan to kind of knock that one down. That'll make it fourth down and 16, and West Alabama will punt, even though they're at the Hawk 35-yard line, trying to pin the Hawks deep one more time. 13:48 remaining in the contest. UWA in control, leading 34-0. Gaines will kick this one end over end towards the corner of the end zone. It will go out of bounds at the 1 yard line. It is fielded and caught at the one. The cover man goes out of bounds right there at the 1 yard line. Mike Kidd, the backup defensive back, just went down there, camped under it, caught it, and fell out of bounds. And so Shorter will take over first and 10 at their own 1 yard line.
Great special teams play right there by Kidd. And, you know, he did. He just fields it. He gets under it kind of like you would a punt return there. And he gets it. He falls out of bounds. And Shorter will have their work cut out for them as they are staring at 99 yards worth of real estate ahead on this first down.
Windham Motor Company is a one-stop shop for sales, services, and parts you need for the vehicle of your dreams. From new to used inventory, the guys from the great metropolis of Demopolis have the ride to fit your style. Visit the website to get pre-approved for an even smoother experience. That's Windham Motor Company, a proud sponsor of UWA Athletics. So Shorter takes over. First and 10 from their own 1 yard line. Pullum has two receivers either way in shotgun formation. Looking to throw over the middle, has a man open. Pass is in and out of Devin Price's hands. Wide open over the middle, and Price could not bring it in.
Pullum just really ramped up. He threw a bullet, and Price just couldn't reel it in. As Shorter's looking at a second down and 10 from their own one here. With 13:37 remaining, Tigers lead here at homecoming 34-0.
Shorter will send three receivers to the right, one receiver to the left. Running back Lanier is to Pullum's left. Pullum looking to throw quick. Hits Lanier out of the backfield across the 5, across the 10. Lanier will be knocked off his feet at the 11-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10, and it will be a first down for the Hawks.
Shamar Lewis in on the stop for West Alabama as Lanier picks up the first down. A few different players kind of getting a little bit of time here for West Alabama. We hit the 13-15 mark as the Tigers lead 34-0 here at homecoming.
Clock approaching 13 minutes left in the game. Tigers showing blitz. They bring pressure. Quick pass is complete along the left sideline. Receiver will be pushed out of bounds at the 28-yard line. Christian Da Silva on the reception and the run after the catch. That will be another Shorter first down. So after starting at their own 1 yard line, they now have it out to their 28. First down and 10 for the Hawks. Hawks will send four receivers to the right, one to the left, empty backfield for Pullum. Pullum will throw, trying to go deep to his receiver, overshoots his intended target. That was Cameron King. There is a penalty flag that was thrown, so you're going to have some type of pass interference or holding call against the West Alabama defense.
Pretty decent pressure up front right there by number 40, Travante Carter, but that's going to be all for naught. And that's what I get for talking about how clean that West Alabama has played this football game today. Another penalty and a big one as it continues to move the chains. A drive that started on the shorter 1 yard line. They now have it first down and 10 from their own 43 yard line.
This time Pullum will have two running backs in the backfield, one to either side of him. Looks to throw, going deep, has a man open, the pass is incomplete, trying to hit his tight end, John Deedle. Deedle wasn't looking for it, he had broken free. If he gets his head around, that has a chance for a big play.
Yeah, it just didn't look like Deedle was expecting that football right there, as it falls incomplete. New personnel coming in for the Hawks. As Pullum looks to the sideline to get the call, they'll be looking at a second down and 10. They're working from their own 43-yard line at the 12:22 mark. Here remaining in the contest, homecoming 2019.
Shorter brings in an H-back. He'll be to the left side of the formation. Pullum looking to throw, getting pressure. Gets away from it. Now Pullum rolls to his right, looking downfield, pumps twice, and throws it right to a Tiger. It is intercepted, but I believe we're going to get a late hit roughing the passer on West Alabama that would negate the interception. That looked like Savon Parker came up with the interception, but there is a penalty flag on the far sideline, which I think will go against West Alabama.
Well, that'll be a tough one because it looked like you were going to have the sack as the head official, Eddie Smith, checks his mic. And check that. Looks like he's going to rethink it here and talk with the other far official. And then Mr. Smith's going to turn on his mic and let us know the call.
So Dorsett Johnson is called for roughing the passer. That'll be a 15-yard penalty. But more importantly, that negates the interception that West Alabama would have had. Pullum just threw it right into the stomach of Savon Parker. Was like a gift on Christmas that you just find there. Parker was able to get his feet in bounds, but that will be wiped away by the penalty. The 15 yards will move the ball into West Alabama territory. The Hawks will have it first and 10 at the UWA 42-yard line inside of 12 minutes left in the game. West Alabama leading 34-0. Pullum looking to throw, getting pressure, dumps it off to his running back Fields, cuts up the middle, has eight, has nine, and they will stop there. And so a good pickup on first down for the Hawks as Pullum was able to escape traffic, dump it off to his running back for a good gain on first down.
Charvez Embry is going to make the stop for West Alabama after about an eight-yard gain. It'll be second down and two for the Hawks. On a drive that the Hawks started at their own one-yard line, they've managed to cover a lot of real estate, in part by 30 yards worth of penalties by the West Alabama Tiger defense.
Pullum will have the Hawks at the line, second and two, fakes the quick pass, now a slant over the middle. A hard hit. The reception is made by Andrew Warren, and then a hard hit by, I believe, was that Jeremiah Boyd on the tackle?
Jeremiah Boyd just flat out parked him right there as it's a huge hit, but West Alabama's defense gives up another first down as the shorter Hawks have it first down and 10 from the Tiger 26.
Terrific job by Warren just to hang on to the football right there. Boyd came in and completely knocked Warren off of his feet. But Warren able to bring it in, hold on to it for the shorter first down. Pullum looking to throw on first down, going towards the end zone. Pass is incomplete again, trying to find his tight end, John Deedle. 6'7 target right there, so you can see why Pullum was trying to connect with him, threw it up in the air, hoping to give Deedle a chance to go up and get it, but just overthrew him by 2 or 3 yards.
Yeah, it's a big target, but he just couldn't bring it down. It falls incomplete. West Alabama with 10:33 remaining here, leading 34-0 over the shorter Hawks. They call Rome, Georgia home. They made the trip over, and they're moving the football here on an extended drive, second down and 10.
Pullum will hand off up the middle. Play will get down to the 21-yard line. Trevor Smith on the carry. He'll pick up about 5 yards, so it'll make it third and a long five for the Hawks.
New personnel getting in there for West Alabama, getting some fresh bodies out there. Number 11, Quanzy Jackson, and number 98, Kamarcus Williams. Some of those big guys up front trying to get a stop here on third down. It'll be third down and five. The shorter Hawks on the Tiger 21-yard line as we hit the 10-minute mark.
Pullum will deploy three receivers left, one to the right, and H-back to the right of the formation. Pullum looking to throw towards the end zone, overshoots his intended receiver, led him just a bit too far in the end zone, and so that'll make it fourth down.
In coverage for the Tigers was number 20. They call him the legend, Jordan Grady. The ball falls incomplete, and Pullum continues to stay out there on the field as they're going to go for it on fourth down. Nothing really to lose here, down 34 to nothing on the road, so they're trying to iron out a few things as Pullum extended look over to the sideline.
Shorter with 13 on the play clock. Now they have the play. Fields the running back to his left, two receivers either way. Pullum looking to throw quick. Pass is nearly intercepted. It's deflected twice and finally picked off by the Tigers. West Alabama comes away with the interception. I believe that was Dorsett Johnson with the pick. Really, you know, we've talked about situations where we want West Alabama to get turnovers. There they get one, and that's really not the right play. You really just want to knock that one down on fourth down and take over. But anyway, you can't fault Dorsett Johnson coming away with the big interception right there to end that drive and for the time being preserve the shutout. 9:33 remaining in the contest. West Alabama leading 34 to nothing.
Kind of crazy that Dorsett Johnson's able to get the interception. That was the same guy that had the penalty that extended Shorter's drive and really put him in that situation. So a payoff right there by the defense, continuing to do big things here as West Alabama has it first down and 10 from their own five.
Be a handoff up the middle. We'll get across the five-yard line, out to the seven, Demetrius Battle on the carry. So it'll be a pickup of about 2.5, maybe 3 yards on first down. West Alabama looking to close this game out, leading 34 to nothing, 9:12 and counting left in the contest. McDaniels has two receivers right, one to the left. Jack looking to throw. Looking to throw, checks the right now, the left now will take off along left end, is hit hard at the 10-yard line, bounces off of that, is hit hard again. And so McDaniels will pick up about 1.5 yards, but took two big shots trying to get towards the sideline.
It looked like Caleb Mason, the linebacker, a freshman for Shorter, took the worst of that as McDaniel is able to extend a welcome, an offensive hit right there for McDaniel. Third down and 4 for West Alabama.
Jack will throw. Pass is complete to Spivey along the left sideline, out across the 20. It'll be enough for the West Alabama first down. Spivey will be brought down at the 23. So a pickup of 12 there on third down extends this West Alabama drive as we approach the 8-minute mark left in the contest. McDaniels will hand off this time to Battle up the middle, bounces off two tacklers, dives forward to the 31-yard line, so a pickup of 8 for Battle on first down.
Battle's 11th carry. He's gone over 60 yards today. He's averaging just over 6 yards per carry. Is this going to be second down and short for the Tigers?
McDaniels will throw here on second down, screen pass to Salisbury, read quickly by the Hawks, and Salisbury will be thrown for a 2-yard loss back to the 28. So that'll make it a third down and five to go for the Tigers.
So a loss of yards right there on a completed pass, and Salisbury was just gang tackled by a whole host of shorter Hawks. Third down and five. Tigers working from their own 31-yard line as we hit the seven-minute mark, and West Alabama leading by 34.
Jack will throw, looks toward Blanchard. Pass is complete out across the 35, makes one man miss, dives forward near the 40. They'll mark him out at the 39. It'll be a pickup of 10 on second and two and a first down for West Alabama.
Blanchard with seven catches. He's got over 100 yards on the afternoon, and he's going to be lined up near side as the officials blow the whistle.
Shorter will take a timeout as they were having a hard time getting substitutions into the game. And so with that, Tiger Athletics would like to say thank you to Big Mike Steakhouse for serving as today's game sponsor. Steaks cooked.
Being a champion takes more than talent, more than the perfect pass, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the spirit to always push harder, the ability to overcome any hurdle, and the fire to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create. And the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
In NCAA Division II, student athletes leave a lasting impression on their communities. That's because Division II student athletes want to make a difference and truly be part of their surrounding communities. Through community engagement, thousands of student athletes from various backgrounds interact with community members who view them as role models. This interaction leaves a positive and perhaps even life-changing impression on all those involved. In Division II, we rise to the opportunity and make community engagement ours.
The wrinkles out now will bode well for the trip to Cleveland next week.
McDaniels will throw, trying to hit Salisbury, does at the 45. Christian breaks away at the 30, 20, 15, 10, 5. Give him six for Christian Salisbury. There's a penalty flag thrown at the 2-yard line. Salisbury turned around and pointed the football at one of the shorter defenders, and that is likely to be an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty. That now, under the new rules, would negate the touchdown, I believe, and be a 15-yard penalty from the point of the unsportsmanlike. And that's exactly what it is, what should have been a 61-yard touchdown strike from McDaniels to Salisbury is wiped off the board because of the unsportsmanlike conduct penalty at the 2-yard line. It'll be a 15-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. It'll be first down and 10 for the Tigers from the shorter 17-yard line.
You don't like it, Robert, but if that's the rule, then you just got to go with it, you know. And it's not like they don't know, so you just got to get some discipline right there. And fortunately, West Alabama's in control right here, but in a close game, that could be a huge detriment.
This will be a handoff to Battle. Battle cuts it towards the outside, is able to get down to the 14-yard line. A pickup of three for the Tigers as we approach the six-minute mark remaining in the contest. West Alabama in complete control, leading 34 to nothing and driving on shorter.
That's just really tough right there to see such a nice play by Salisbury, because he's got some separation speed just negated by, you know, a choice that he made. But West Alabama's looking at a second down and seven from the Hawks 15.
McDaniels will flip it out on the far side, trying a quick pass to Deion Hill. It is complete, but it will lose yardage back to the 17 in what appeared to be a lateral right there, trying to get it quickly to Hill, the wide receiver in motion, but it will lose yardage back to the 17, so it'll lose the 2 yards that Battle had gotten on first down, and it'll make it third and 10 with 5:15 remaining in the contest. Jack looking to throw on third, looking to go to Martin. Back shoulder fade, has it. Martin extends for the pylon. He's got it. Touchdown, West Alabama. 17-yard strike from Jack McDaniels to Tyreek Martin.
Tyreek Martin grabs his third touchdown pass of the year. It was a pretty sweet ball. It was just kind of that back shoulder throw, and Martin was able to get his body around and then have enough field awareness to get his shoulder square, then reaches over for the touchdown as West Alabama will attempt a PAT. Bailey Blanchard in to hold. Zach Gaines in to do the kicking here as West Alabama leads 40-0 with 5:05. The snap is low. Bailey Blanchard gets the kick, the hold down, the kick is up, and it goes through. And just like that, West Alabama extends the lead here on your station for West Alabama Football, ESPN, and ESPN1049.com.
.505 remaining in the contest. West Alabama in complete control, leading 41-0. Something that I did not expect to see. Appears Quay Boyd is in to handle the kickoff duties. Boyd straight ahead kick, end over end kick that will reach the 8. It will be returned along the left sideline out across the 30. Will finally be knocked out of bounds at the 35-yard line. And so Quay Boyd, the All-American tight end, going old school, handling the kickoff duties, just a straight-ahead kick like you would see at the high school level, but Boyd able to take some of those responsibilities off of Zach Gaines' right leg as he has been busy today handling not only punting duties, but also handling extra points and kickoffs up to that point.
If we could have just gotten him a square-toed shoe, we would have had everything that we wanted to see right there. As Shorter will take over first down and 10. They're going to be working from their 36-yard line with 4:59 remaining here. Tigers lead 41-0.
Handoff along left side to Fields. He will reach the 37.5-yard line. Only pickup of a yard, maybe a yard and a half there for Shorter. On first down as Aeneas Dennis is into the game for the second time at quarterback coming into today. Dennis had only attempted 10 passes, completing 5 of them for a total of 46 yards. Dennis is an athletic quarterback, one who is more prone to run it than throw it. And just as I say it, Dennis looking to throw, looking to go downfield, flush from the pocket, will run, get across the 40, will reach the 44-yard line, but there is a penalty flag on the field. It was thrown right at the line of scrimmage.
Dennis kind of rolled out to his right, was looking to throw, and then he starts to just kind of tuck it and run as Eddie Smith makes his way to make the call.
Charvez Embry will be called for offsides for the Tigers. And so that'll be a 5-yard penalty. They'll take the yards and replay second down. It'll be second and 4 for the Hawks. 4:13 and counting left in the game. West Alabama leading 41-0. Dennis, shotgun formation. 3 receivers left, 1 to the right. Dennis looking to throw, getting pressure, moves up in the pocket, now rolls to his left, will go downfield, 45, will cross midfield where they'll mark him there. It'll be a pickup of 9 yards for Aeneas Dennis and a shorter first down.
Jeremiah Boyd in on the stop, and right there was a good example of what you're talking about, Robert, is an athletic quarterback able to use his feet, and he's able to get it out to midfield. His shorter's looking at a first down and 10. They're at midfield, 3:35 remaining. West Alabama leading here at homecoming, 41-0.
West Alabama looking to preserve this shutout. Dennis will have an empty backfield, 4 receivers right, 1 to the left. Dennis, quick pass to the right side of the formation. Pass is complete. It will get into West Alabama territory. Short will be marked down at the 46-yard line.
In on the stop for West Alabama is going to be number 26. That's Lavorsier Gaddis, defensive back from Auburn, Alabama. He's brings him down after a gain of about 4. Second down and 6 for the Hawks.
West Alabama trying to shut out an opponent for the first time since 2017 when West Alabama shut out these same shorter Hawks. Dennis, with flags on the play, will scramble around right end. He will pick up 9. It's going to be an offsides against the Tigers. West Alabama was blitzing on the play in the corner on the far sideline, tried to time up the snap and had his timing off by just a little bit. So it'll be a 5-yard penalty against the Tigers. Replay second down. Now it will be 2nd and 1 from the West Alabama 41-yard line. 2:30 remaining in the game. West Alabama leading 41-0 over Shorter. Dennis will hand off up the middle. Trevor Smith with the carry. He'll pick up about 4 yards before he's thrown backwards, but it's enough for a shorter first down.
West Alabama's defense, not what you want to see right here, is the sticks continuing to move here as we're approaching the 2-minute mark. First down and 10 for Shorter. They're on the Tiger 37. Looks like they're going to have 3 wide receivers here to the near side, 1 at the numbers to the far side.
Dennis looks to throw. Pass is incomplete. Nearly picked off that time by Caleb Abram. Dennis trying to complete a slant. Abram read the route better than the wide receiver did, made a break on it, was able to get a hand on it, just could not bring it in. Pass goes incomplete. It'll be 2nd and 10 for Shorter. 1:47 remaining in the game.
West Alabama's defense looking at this 2nd down and 10. Sun's pretty much set here in Livingston as Shorter's 2nd down from the Tiger 37.
Dennis, empty backfield, looking to throw. Quick pass is complete across the 30. Will reach the West Alabama 25-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 12 and enough for another shorter first down as we are at 1:40 remaining in the game.
1:40 remaining. West Alabama's defense desperately trying to lock it up right here. The game is in hand, but you'd love to see them pitch this shutout if that's possible.
Dennis will have 3 receivers left, 1 to the right. Fields the running back to his right. Dennis will move up in the pocket. He will scramble forward inside the West Alabama 20. Is hit low and then is hit high. Goes down hard at the 16. It'll be a pickup of 9. Dennis took a shot on that play.
Jordan Jones was the delivery of said shot. He was the guy that caught him up kind of high right there. Dennis definitely paid the price for that one, and it come up just shy of the first down mark, so it'll be 2nd down and short. As we hit the 105 mark remaining here in the contest.
empty backfield for the Hawks. Three receivers left, one to the right, an H-back to the right of the formation. Dennis drops back to throw, throws towards the right side of the field. Nobody home. Dennis was getting pressure and just had to get rid of that one before he got sacked.
Yeah, Trey Elson was just barreling down on him right there, and I don't think it was in as much as he was trying to get it to someone as he was trying not to get himself drilled. Smart move on his behalf. So it'll be third down and one for the Hawks. They're on the Tigers' 16-yard line with 53.4 seconds remaining here as West Alabama leads by 41.
Dennis surveying the defense. Tigers showing blitz. They bring it. Dennis in trouble, escapes up the middle, has it at the 10, pushes forward inside the 5. He's finally met by several Tigers who will bring him down at the 4-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 12 and a first down for Shorter. Clock stops with 43 and a half seconds remaining as Shorter will call a timeout, trying to get some points on the board here.
Lavoisier, Gaddis, and company in on the stop right there. And on the afternoon, with just 43 and a half seconds left, West Alabama has amassed 557 total yards of offense, 326 in the air, 231 on the ground. The penalties, what we thought were going to be after the first half, kind of kept in check. They've done everything that they could to try to creep up to that average, as they've got 8 penalties for 85 yards.
The gold standard of inventions might be sliced bread, but we know differently. We know there's only one cheesy, saucy, delicious treat that just about everyone can agree is one of humankind's most shining achievements, pizza. Granted, we might be a bit biased, but since there's such thing as National Pizza Month, we can't be too far off. After all, sliced bread doesn't get its own month. No one is more passionate about pizza than Pizza Hut. It's in our name, and it always will be. Pizza Hut, a proud sponsor of UWA Athletics. 43 and a half seconds remaining. West Alabama leading. Shorter 41 to nothing, but Shorter has it first and goal at the UWA 4-yard line, trying to get on the scoreboard. Aeneas Dennis, the backup quarterback, in. He is under center. Dennis will fake the handoff, roll to the left, looking to throw now, will dump it off, and it's picked off by West Alabama. Caleb Abram comes up with a big interception to preserve this shutout.
Nice job right there by Abram, as he just read it all the way, and he's able to get in there, get his hands on it, and a nice turnover right there, which will preserve this homecoming shutout here, 2019.
Dennis right there faked the handoff and rolled out to his left. If Dennis just keeps it, he can probably walk into the end zone, but he elected to try and throw it, and threw it right in to the breadbasket of Caleb Abram, who was able to get the ball, get both feet down for the interception. So 36.7 seconds remaining in the game. All West Alabama have to do will kneel it once, and the ball game is over. Shorter was flagged for an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty, and I believe that went against their head coach, showing a little bit of the frustration which comes with losing your 45th consecutive game and losing today 41 to nothing.
Yeah, it's just tough. You know, these kids, they prepare and they want to win and that type of thing, and they're just, you know, in the GSC right now, they're a bit outmatched. And, you know, West Alabama on a day that they weren't just perfect, they were definitely the superior team. As we're going to take a knee, and that'll let this one run out here in the happy final in Livingston, West Alabama 41 and the Shorter Hawks 0.
Jacob Murphy with the final play, kneeling down on his right knee. And as you said, that will do it here on homecoming for West Alabama. UWA, as the final seconds tick off the clock, will defeat Shorter 41 to nothing. Big victory for the Tigers to get back on the winning side of things, and also pitching their first shutout in two seasons. 41-0 is our final. We'll be back in just a few minutes to wrap things up from a very happy Tiger Stadium.
Being a champion takes more than talent, more than the perfect pass, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the spirit to always push harder, the ability to overcome any hurdle, and the fire to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create. And the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
On homecoming in Livingston, Alabama, West Alabama is able to pick up the victory 41-0 over Shorter, and Will got contributions from all three phases of the game.
Absolutely. I mean, you saw Jack McDaniel. He went 25 of 33. He threw a pick, but he was able to find the end zone three times. He had 326 yards of total offense. He spread the football around today. He had nine different receivers leading the way. Bailey Blanchard had seven catches for 109 yards and a touchdown. He averaged almost 16 yards per catch. Quay Boyd got into the mix today, three catches for a touchdown of his own. Tyreek Martin, James Smith, Derek Underwood, each with three catches. Salisbury had two. McMillan had two. Spivey had a catch. And Deion Hill with a catch. James Smith led the way with 10 carries for 150 yards today. He had a touchdown. His long of 65, he averaged 15 yards per carry. Demetrius Battle, 12 carries, 70 yards, and a touchdown, just under 6 yards per. And Underwood had six carries for 22 yards and a touchdown. So great job right there as West Alabama is able to amass 555 total yards of offense, 326 in the air, 229 on the ground, and just an overall iron it all out, get ready to go to Delta State type of afternoon on homecoming.
West Alabama did exactly what they needed, exactly what they wanted to today in picking up the victory. Shorter moves to 0-6 on the season. Next week, they will host North Greenville. West Alabama moves to 4-2 overall, 1-2 in GSC play, setting up a huge matchup next weekend at Delta State, Cleveland, Mississippi. Kick is at 6 p.m. We will be on the air at 5:45. So encourage everyone, if you cannot make the trip to Cleveland, Mississippi, tune us in. We'll have all the action right here on ESPN 104.9 starting at 5:45 next weekend from Cleveland, Mississippi. Once again, your final on a very happy homecoming, West Alabama 41, Shorter nothing. For Will Atkinson, I'm Robert Upchurch. Good night, and go Tigers.